Alrighty, where is it? Can you see our ugly mugs?
Yes, we can see
Ooh.
our ugly mug.
Ah! Ooh.
Yeah.
It's rough. It's a rough image to get used to. But, where there's a will, there's a way, right?
Yeah.
As they say. Alright, shoot. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna do. I have to hit this too. Who's gonna. Do you wanna say it? You want me to say it?
Good set.
Okay.
TNTM, the show presents Comicast 250
with your host
Pablo Gunner
and JD. How's it going, everybody?
and we are here to review comics for the week of.
Was this week? It was the
We
what?
didn't do it.
About the second or third?
What's the research? Is it? No, I think it's the 31st, wasn't it? Or was that the last week?
I think
Is
that was
this the
last
first
week.
week? Okay, I'm.
So maybe it was the 6th, because today's the 10th.
It is. Let me check my calendar. The
Yeah,
7th? The 7th.
yeah, so we get the
My
7th.
calendar is saying that it is the 7th.
September to the 7th.
Usually we're more prepared than this, but
Yeah.
nope, less prepared for 250th.
Yeah.
That's how we intended on it.
Ad lib, we're winging
Yeah.
it.
Wing it. Night winging it, actually.
Yeah, night
That's
winging it.
I'm doing that now.
Yeah,
That's my
that's
new thing.
you're night winging it.
Yes, for sure.
Hang on, that's so
So
we got a title for the podcast now. Night winging it.
night winging it?
Yeah.
Maybe. There's
Yeah.
a good chance.
That's fun.
Thanks. Thank you for helping me fix the disposal.
It's
Love
good.
you.
It's good to see you again.
Love you
Take
too. Hope you enjoyed your
care,
meal.
everyone.
It was
It was
good to see you
good.
again.
See, now Dad's off the hook. Can I
turn? You're welcome.
Thank you. I
There's your set. I still owe you, okay?
Still need money.
So we, as you can tell, we are live.
Yes,
We are
we are
not
live.
corpses. We are live.
That is true. These are true facts right here. That was my familia right there leaving. They came over to help me fix the disposal because I couldn't figure it out. I was messing. I was like a monkey. I was like an
You're
ape.
gonna
They're just
beat it with a
banging.
hammer?
Yeah, I really was. I was like, there's all the gunk, and I'm like, what? Like, I had to like breathe through my mouth, It was sad. For 3 hours. For three
Oh
hours I
man,
was doing that.
brutal.
Anyways, we are here to review comics.
And not the garbage disposals.
Yes, but we're live, so we're just, we're doing this, I guess.
Have you been able to share this on social media so we can get some people on the page? Okay.
I don't know. I posted on our Facebook just now that we're on the Ustream.
All right,
So.
I posted a few minutes ago to check it out in the community. So
Oh, okay, awesome.
hopefully we'll get some people in here shortly, talking to
Somewhat.
us.
Right, and
But
people can hit us up wherever. Like, on our Hotmail or our email or whatever it is, right?
yeah,
YouTube, our Facebook, any of them,
so
they can hit them up.
250. How many weeks is that? How many years is that?
We do them every week.
This is
I
about
don't feel like we've
almost 5 years.
I don't think we've missed any in a long time.
That's almost 5 years of podcasting.
And it's weird because like I'll go on vacation and we'll do catch-up episodes. Or somehow we'll make it work,
If that's the case, I'll be
So
here
it's
to
evened
help.
out. So
I take notes when need to. But we are here to review comics. So let's go through and get started on this week's comics again, which is for September the 7th.
September the 7th. So let me. I didn't even do this either. I didn't even find a
It didn't
tune.
find a
I didn't
tune.
even find a tune yet. But I'm just gonna go down the list.
Ooh. Somebody look at phone.
So, sounds like, my parents, I guess.
The folks with the phones.
So,
No
but that's
bueno.
the tone. If you know what it is,
It is.
then.
It sounds like very familiar from a video game,
Yes.
and it sounds from a awesome platformer, possibly, maybe even a racing game. But yeah, we're gonna have great fun. are going to go through and just kind of wing this because I'm...
And I'm back. I'm back. Sorry.
We're prepared. We've read all the comics that we got. We just can't prep for the show.
This is what happens when you do a live stream, and this is why we don't do live streams, yeah. I feel like. So
it's better edited.
Yeah.
With awesome sound effects.
So that's the sound that's going to go off when we're reviewing. Did you cover that?
No, I did not.
When it's time to wrap it up, we wrap it up within like a minute or so.
Like the Oscars.
Yes. If you know, and like I said, if you know what that is, tell me. I'll send you a free digital code.
And you have to be very, very specific.
Yes, yes. Because I did have one person, they're like, oh, that's from Super Mario. And I'm like, but
what
which
game?
One?
What yeah, level?
Which sound? Because they tend to use a lot of the same ones in songs, which is fine. So, but it's like for what, you know, because there's like the I Beat a Level song, you know.
Yeah.
There's like the, you know, where you pick the, you do like the mini games
there's
or whatever.
There's Star Road stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's different ones.
Themes.
But anyways, that's the one for this week. 1 minute if we're reviewing it by ourselves.
And
two minutes
together.
If we're doing it together. And then, and yeah, and so when we review it, we have our grade scale.
By, skim, pass,
yes.
Variations on the skim, and variations on the by. Strong by, strong skim, weak skim.
I'm going to throw some lights on so it's not...
Let there be light.
Dark. I know some peeps want to see this bod, so I'm not going to rob them, you know.
So. There's light.
Yes. So, here we are. I'm back.
And we have our book of the week.
Yes, our best book of the week, Bebow, Back and Bag.
Of the week.
Yeah, and it's the best one. That's where we'll drop the most spoilers, so spoiler alert.
Yeah,
there will be spoilers,
because some of these books this week were really good, and stuff that I didn't think I would pick up, I did pick up.
Yeah, there's books that I didn't want to pick up, but I had already ordered them because I didn't know that they were going to go downhill.
And some of those books I was impressed with.
So, yeah, some of them were cool. Some of them, eh. But, yeah, so we're going to do this. We're going to review our books. Feel free to hit us up, you know, while we're doing this.
Yep.
And everything like that, so...
Alrighty, so first off, we have All New, All Different Avengers number 14, which is a Civil War II tie-in. Written by Mark Waid and Jeremy Whitley. Artist by Adam Kubert. And color artist, Asanya Obeck. And in short, we start out with the Wasps. How do you pluralize that?
Yeah,
Wasps.
Wasps. It's just a lot of S's.
So we have Nadia Pym and Janet Van Dyne.
Nadia's already a hot name, but she's young, so it's weird.
How old is she? She's like 16?
I don't know.
And she seems to be wearing a variation of Janet's original suit.
And kind of like Hank Pym-ish, too.
Yeah, all this really technology. But they're approached by Russian security, I guess.
Consulate. It's security guards, and they're like, "Hey, you ran away from Russia. We're taking you back
because
you don't have a right to be here." And at first, they're going with
Like, "Yeah, okay. Well, I don't want to cause any trouble. Let's go and check it out." And they're like, "Okay, let me see your papers." And
they just have some attention to detail there and get things kind of cleared up, sort of, so to speak. And then Nadia does her Hank Pym thing, which is, I'm going to fix this with science, you know?
She's really upset that... Well, I guess what we see here is an image from Civil War number 5. We have not yet been released yet.
Right, yeah. There's an image that's like Luke Cage
fighting
Blue Marvel, and I'm like, what? Where is this from? Because that looks cool.
I mean, it's just like a one panel of, you know, Iron Man and Captain Marvel, Hawkeye shooting an arrow through somebody's chest, what it looks like. And then Luke Cage fighting, is this Nick Fury?
Who's that? Oh, no, that's Blue Marvel.
Blue Marvel, okay.
So.
And she's like, okay, well, I'm going to do what Dad did. Fix this with science.
And she goes into the subatomic world, the microverse.
Microverse.
She has like her own lab in the microverse, which is really
neat.
And
it's a really sick lab.
Yeah, it's really, really cool.
And basically what happens is she fails. And Janet gives her the realization that it's not a science problem that needs to be fixing. It's a human problem.
Yes.
And that, I'm sorry, that touches me in the feels right there, because that's what this is. It's a difference of opinions, and it's a human problem, and it does need to be worked out, but it's only going to work out on its own.
Yeah.
And then I guess towards the end, the last page, we get like a flashback. It seems like it's Hank, Jarvis, and Nadia, and but I'm kind of lost on that, so... Yeah, that one. That page. I was totally lost on that page right there.
I don't see any Hank.
Well, who's this talking to the little girl? I mean, I don't know who these people
That's,
are.
That's... What's her name? That's, Janet.
Oh. Oh, now I get it. Okay. So she is young. Very young.
I wonder if they're ever going to bring... Well, Hank.
You mean Hank Ultron?
Hank Ultron back at some point, though. You know what I mean? Like,
and since he has a daughter now, I mean...
Yeah.
Yeah, Ultron spits out a freaking human. I mean, that'd be kind of weird.
Yeah, for sure.
But anyway, I would give this a strong buy. I thought this was a really good title. I didn't expect this to kind of hit me in the feels like it did. But, man, this is very human plot. There's not much action in here at all. It really develops the characters. Yeah, strong buy, and I think it's a contender for me.
Yeah, I was impressed with Kubert's art, too, because I think of the two artists, he's not as good. But anyways, he did a really solid job. So yeah, strong buy as well. Here's a digital code. F for Familia, C for Carlos, M for Marcos, C for Carlos, X for Javier, with an X. Xavier.
Xavier, yeah.
Yeah. H for Hector, 5, K for... Kill? I don't know. U for Ultron, Z for Zarbon, L for Lopez, and J for Jones. I just lost it halfway through.
Yeah. So people who are watching this live can get that code first.
Yes. Yeah.
So keep that in mind.
Yeah. Yeah. Get those codes live.
Yeah. Now we have the Invincible Iron Man. Which number is number 13?
13,
also
yeah.
A Civil War title. Written by Brian Michael Bendis, Mike Diodato. Diodato is being the artist, and Frank Martin doing the colors.
Yes.
And this was a very somber issue.
It's weird, man. Oh. Like, Dr. Doom is just, like, messing with his life, and you really don't know why he's doing this.
Yeah.
I don't understand it myself.
I don't either. What
and
does
I
want to
know
gain?
What his deal is. Yeah, like, why?
Victor doesn't do anything unless he can gain something from it.
Usually, yeah.
And, you know, it's hard to tell what he's up to, but he's trying to help Tony through this difficult time. And he brings Tony to Amara, is what her name is?
I think so.
Dr. Amara. And kind of reunites with her. And then... Eventually, the comic gets to the point where he's just trying to grieve for Rhodey.
Right.
And it's Rhodey's funeral. And everybody's like, hey, why aren't you at his funeral? Even MJ is in there. Yes, my main lady, MJ, Mary Jane, is in the comic. And she's like, hey, they're all wondering why you're not there. He's your best friend. Oh, okay. I'm going to let you grieve on your own. Because that's kind of how it happens.
Yeah.
And... So I feel that them delaying Civil War number 5 makes this comic have a lot more impact.
For sure.
Because you get to see him grieving and going, hey, I'm really hurting here. And then it's like, how is he going to react? How is he going to go through and resolve this?
Yeah, I really like the flashback that was them like facing off against Crimson Dynamo.
Oh, yeah.
Some old school suits and stuff. That was cool. I think my favorite was the ending with Doom. I'm not going to go into it.
Me neither, because it was humorous to me.
It's just too good to be true.
It's too John Travolta, if you get my drift.
So, yeah. It's.
If you see it, you'll know what I'm talking about. Very, very 80s, late 70s, early 80s Travolta, if you get my reference.
So,
but, yeah. Check out this comic. It's a
strong
buy.
It's definitely a strong buy, without a doubt.
This is also a contender for me.
Okay, cool.
So we have Silk.
Yes. You read Silk?
Yes, I did.
Oh, cool. Silk number 12, with Robbie Thompson as a writer, Tana Ford as the artist, Ian Herring as color artist.
And we start out in the negative zone.
Yes.
Pretty much.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, we get a small flashback.
Her with her friends, and it gets crazy, and there's like, okay, somebody was camping out over here.
There's parachutes.
Yes.
They're trying to find Silk's mom and dad.
Mm.
And that's why they're in the negative zone. And her best friends, she told them her secret identity, but they'd already figured it out because, you know, they're not stupid. I mean,
right.
It's not like she had glasses on and took them off and everything like that. But, yeah, we see Silk doing stuff with her powers, making the webbing weaves and going through and following the trail of breadcrumbs, more or less. And then they come across this town, which is, like, kind of right out of, you know, Game of Thrones / Lord of the Rings.
Yes.
And there's a lot of Game of Thrones and Lord of the Rings references that point on.
It's fantastic. Which I love because Silk is the one that says the ones that's Lord of the Rings because that took place before she went into the bunker. But her friends are the ones that are mentioning the Game of Thrones ones, which she doesn't get because
she doesn't have HBO Go yet.
Yes.
And she even says that.
Up. Yeah.
She talks to a dragon, of all things. A talking dragon.
Yes. So,
hence, again, the Game of Thrones references, I guess.
Well, I don't think they talk in Game of Thrones.
I don't think so either, but still.
But definitely in Lord of the Rings, for sure. Smaug. And then the ending was crazy.
Yeah, they're like, okay, go talk with this Red Knight over here in town. And they'll know what's going on. They came around the same time. There was other strangers coming in here. And Cindy goes and helps out the knight. And makes a big discovery about the knight's identity.
It's crazy. It's awesome. I'm loving it. I'm loving where it's going. It's so good. I felt like Tana Ford's art fit this issue a lot better. Because it's just like all this fantasy stuff just worked really well with it. So I give this one a strong buy.
Definitely. I give it a strong buy, but I don't think it's a contender. But I am definitely going to start reading this title a lot more now because I might have missed the first, you know, couple of arcs, I guess, but I'm picking up the title here. I'm going to start from here. I'm really interested in it. This is something that made me want to buy it, and I will continue reading it.
Getting invested.
Invested.
There you go, right on.
And there goes that fishing hook.
Boom. What do they say? Sink, line, and hooker, right?
Yeah, sink, line, and hooker. Hook, line, and sinker.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, anyways, I have a digital code if you want to check it out. F for fan, C for camera, M for monk, 2-1, K for kill, 1 for Inca, H for hotel, W for Wolverine, J for Jarbon, Q for Quill, and X for X-Men.
Alrighty. And moving along, we have a title that I did not pick up.
What's that? Doctor Strange number 11?
I did not pick up
Doctor Strange. Jason Aaron writing.
No.
Artists Kevin Nowlan and Leonardo Romero. Colors Kevin Nowlan and Jordi Belair. This is a title I actually had. I had already ordered it. I wasn't going to pick it up, and not because it's bad, but because I wanted to switch to... trade, but it's so good, and it's kind of a departure, obviously, because of the art change, and so it goes a lot into the past, a lot of his past stuff, you know, like when his hands were messed up, and he was learning about magic, and he had the choice, and he's seeing how, like, there's slowly magic coming back to the world, and how some spells aren't working, a lot of spells aren't working, some are. He has to use, like, enchanted weapons now. So it's kind of cool that he has to use enchanted weapons because it's, like, now he's, like, beating stuff up with, like, weapons, you know, instead of just being, like, the Eye of Agamotto sees that you're a bad dude or whatever. I don't know. You know what I mean?
The Crimson, like, Rings of Sidorak.
Yes. And he says, like, some crazy stuff, some crazy spells, and it sounds, like, goofy. And you're, like, man, this guy's a dweeb. But yeah, and they're bringing Mordo back, which is really cool. Like, this is a really bad time for Mordo to show up.
Baron Mordo.
So yeah, it's great stuff. It's just gold. It is gold.
I think that they'll probably try and reboot this series a little bit closer to the movie release. They'll probably try and drum up something, some big drastic change to get everybody to read it.
Sure, sure. I've heard a lot of people are reading it just because it's been so well done and so well illustrated. But I give this one a strong buy, and I'm holding on to some of the digital codes. Every other code I give away, and every other code I keep for Talking Nerdy Vlogcast.
Yeah, so check out the Talking Nerdy Vlogcast this week.
For sure.
And we have Spidey, you know what, number 10?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it's written by Robbie Thompson, and Nathan Stockman is the artist, and the colors are done by Jim Campbell. And we have classic Spidey. I mean, like, what, 15-year-old?
Yeah.
So maybe year one. I suppose it should be called Spidey Year One.
Yeah, but they kind of update it with, like, technology and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
I really like this one because it has Cap when he was more of, like, a street-level dude, and he actually, like, fought crime in the neighborhood.
Like, pretty Maximum Carnage.
Yeah, he's like, I'm on watch. Do you want to go on watch with me? I mean, they're both New Yorkers. Yeah. They're just different...
Different styles.
Different neighborhoods and stuff. And
Cap's like a big hero. I mean, he's the super soldier. He's the hero of World War II.
Yeah.
And he's probably, like, freshly defrosted at this point in time. And they kind of make a few Capsicle jokes here and there.
Yeah.
It's pretty funny.
Yeah, it's great, man. So they team up, and then they end up taking on AIM.
And MODOK.
Oh, my God. I loved it. And I was like, yes! 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 Not enough MODOK in comics. Like, MODOK is so ridiculous. That he's just so great.
Who would you want to see play MODOK in the MCU?
Tommy Lee Jones.
As MODOK.
Yes! I don't know why, but he's already, I'm just saying,
you know,
that.
Colonel Philip, his name, you know?
Oh, yeah, he is. So I forgot about that. Yeah, you can't do that. Never mind. Yeah, I don't know. That was just off the top of my head. I don't know who would actually be, like, a legit... Steve Buscemi would be great.
Steve Buscemi is MODOK. Marvel, please make it happen. It would be great. I would watch it, and I would enjoy it.
No doubt. No doubt,
or
for sure.
Or maybe Gary Busey.
I don't know. Busey might be...
Or Jake Busey.
So perfect. I'm not sure.
Maybe Jake Busey since he's younger, you know?
But... Yeah, everything about it I just love.
But Spidey and Cap, they take out AIM and MODOK, and, you know, it's captioned on camera and stuff. You know, your typical JJJ thing happens where he's like, oh, he's a menace. Spider-Man is a menace, and he's working with AIM. And Cap's like, nah.
Cap shows up.
Nah,
yeah,
that
like,
ain't
nope,
happening.
We teamed up and we took down
You're
AIM
gonna
together.
You're going to print this.
Yeah.
And he even looks at the stash.
Oh, man.
It was so epic to see the stash.
Oh, my gosh. I didn't notice that.
You didn't notice the stash?
No way. Yeah, I just noticed that now.
Oh, man.
That is so funny.
I had to go back and reread that page. I was like,
no.
Why were they focusing on the stash so much? And then they make him shave it. And that's why Spidey's at the end of the window going, hey, good job.
Okay, this is a strong buy, without a doubt.
This is totally a contender. Strong buy.
This is absolutely a contender.
This book up.
Here's a digital code. Check it out. Tell us what you think. H for home, W for work, H for home, F for Frank, 9, E for Echo, 1, F for Frank, V for Vegeta, G for George, 7, C for Charlie.
And next, we have Moon Knight, number 6, and is written by Jeff Lemire. And artist is Wilfredo Torres, Francisco Frankenvilla, and James Stoke. I guess it's Stoke. Stoke.
Francesco Francavilla.
And the colors are done by Michael Garland, Francisco Francavilla, and James Stoke, or whatever his name is.
Stoke.
Anyway. But it looks like, all right, this one's really trippy. Yeah. It starts out with them, like, making a movie.
Yes.
I mean, I have a feeling that this is all inside Mark's head, because you see Mark, but his name is not Mark, and people accidentally keep dropping and calling his name as Mark throughout the whole comic.
By accident, yeah.
And it's like, oh, no, that was just a slip of the tongue, and, you know, it's a character or something like that. I've been rehearsing lines. I just keep making up some really weird excuses.
Yes.
And, but yeah, it's, I feel that it's, his personalities are splintering, and somebody's trying to mess with his mind. They say he's in, like, a mental hospital somewhere in the comic. And they actually go to this mental hospital in the comic.
Yes.
I mean, I'm totally confused, but the stylization, it was just awesome. It's just fantastic. So, yeah. If you can't make heads or tails of it like me, but think it's a really good noir mystery, then pick this up.
It blows my mind.
I was totally surprised. I did not want to initially pick this up. I skipped through it, and I was like, okay, well, art looks great. You know, I'll check it out.
It's really weird.
Oh, yeah.
It is so
psychological.
Weird. Yes, and that's where you get the art changes. There's two different art changes, one where it's Francesco Francavilla, and, like, he goes to being a cabbie, and it's really weird. So, yeah, it just doesn't make any sense. And then where... there's the other one where he's like a pilot or some crap like that.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what? It's just weird, dude. Like, and like I said, those are the two different, they're two different artists, those two. And like you said, Francesco Francavilla does that noir stuff perfectly where he was a cabbie.
Like a space adventure.
And then that space adventure, it's like, it looks like Robotech style.
It's like Robotech meets The Last Starfighter.
Yeah. It's freaking awesome. It's freaking amazing. So
I mean, I don't know about it being a strong buy because my confusion was just kind of outweighed everything, but it's definitely a good buy.
I know. Well, I because I know that these guys are just like mind-blowingly brilliant.
I mean, I think I need some acid before I start start reading that book.
No,
man.
It would be way too much. Like, it's already trippy. You don't need to add anything to it because then you're done.
That is just mind-boggling.
Yeah, definitely. So I give it a strong buy, and I give it a contender, because it just blows my mind.
And that's the last of the Marvel books that we read this week. So we will continue on with our next books in a moment, after we talk about our sponsor for the week.
Yes, our sponsor for the week. Who are we talking about for our sponsor for the week?
The viewer.
The viewer is the sponsor for
yeah,
the week?
The viewers, yes.
Yeah, they could. Yeah, go ahead, donate to our PayPal, you know. Go for it. I don't know. I'm going to ring down everything all at once.
Sounds good.
So, we got Age of Comics, that's one of our sponsors.
Yep.
Say it at the top of the show. And they're like, if you're looking for like a legit hardcore comic book
home
place
comic.
And experience, like that's it. They're just about comics and they are the best. Like, you know, the way I think of it is kind of like, I like to consider them kind of like the Led Zeppelin of comic book stores.
Led Zeppelin of comic
where, you know how, like, each person in that band, they were perfectly great at their instrument, you know?
But together, they were this awesome force of nature.
Yes. So they were the best of each of each thing.
Which, you know, John Paul Jones is still awesome if you know, check out the Crooked Vultures. Yeah, great.
And even, yeah, the other guys that did their own things did good stuff,
well,
still do good stuff. But anyways,
yeah.
The other sponsor, I like to consider them like the Beatles, where they may not be the best at one thing, but they're the best at many things. Or not the best, but they're really good at a lot of things, which is they do tabletop gaming. They have statues. They have the
comics.
Card gaming. They have comics. They
Trades.
Have graphic novels. They have clothing. Like, they have it all, but they know it all, too, you know? So, they're the jack of all trades, you know,
yeah.
Is what it is. You see there? And then, of course, we have Gamers Anonymous.
Hold on, we didn't even drop the name of that previous...
Oh, Twin Sons?
Yeah.
Twin Sons.
Yeah,
I didn't mention that it was Twin Sons?
No, we didn't mention it was Twin Sons.
Twin Sons is the jack of all trades, Twin Sons Comics and Games.
Yes.
So, yeah.
And then, if we're specifically talking about games... we have Gamers Anonymous.
Video games,
yeah.
Yes.
Yes, not tabletop or card games, video games.
Uh-huh.
Like PS4 classic games for like PS2, and I don't know. Have you seen any Atari games there?
I think they do have Atari games, but
that's probably about as far back as you can go.
Yeah,
really.
ColecoVision. Yeah.
Well, I mean, I used to have a Commodore 64 back in the day, but that was way back in the day. I don't even know what kind of cartridges they would take anymore.
Yeah.
But
so,
Gamers Anonymous and Super Gamers Anonymous here in Albuquerque, one's on what, Corrales Road and what's the cross street again for Corrales?
Alameda.
Yeah, Alameda and Corrales Road, and then Wyoming and Constitution for the other one.
Yes. And so in my video, I said go to them because I did a Talking Nerdy vlogcast where I reviewed.
Was it Destiny?
Destiny actually got a lot of hits. I was surprised. I barely even promoted it that much. I did on a few places. But anyways, I borrowed that from them because we have a sweet deal set up. And so that game is available at their store right now, Destiny. So in the video, I say go to them for all your retro gaming needs. But guess what? Not just retro.
Nope.
Like, they have PS4 games. They're used. They have, actually, they do have some new PS4 and Xbox One games that are brand new. But, in fact, they had the Taken King. I'm tempted to go back, but I know that I'm not leveled up enough to probably try the Taken King.
My next new game is going to be Xenoverse 2. That's my next new game. Oh, yeah.
Sweetness.
I'm a Dragon Ball fan. I love me some
Dragon Ball. So that's not like part of the Xeno Chronicles or Xeno Blades or Xeno...
Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2.
So it's something different then.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
If you're a Dragon Ball fan, check it out. It's a great game. I bought my original first one for like $20 off the PlayStation Store for all the DLC and stuff. So it wasn't a bad deal, and I tried it out, and I was like, yeah, I like it. So I'm going to get the next one. So anyway, after talking about our sponsors, back to comics.
Yes. Back to some books.
So what we have here is Batman, number 6, written by Tom King. Ivan Reis is the pencils. Is it Reis or Rice?
Reyes. I don't know. I like to say Reyes.
Joe Prado and Eau Claire Albert and Scott Hanna did the inks. And Marcelo Maiolo did the colors for this issue. And this was a really strange issue.
I didn't even want to get this.
I really didn't either.
Unfortunately, it already ordered it because I didn't know it was going to be garbage. And so, I don't know. How did you feel about it?
I mean, it's almost like the stages of grief. You know, you have disbelief, you have the anger, you have... I mean, it really delves into the character of Gotham Girl. And it kind of tries to flesh out what she is without, Gotham, Hank, her brother, whatever.
Well, she's, like, talking to her brother. And
yeah.
He's dead.
He's,
and she shaved her. She pulled a Britney, shaved her head.
Yeah,
Hank's
a little corpsey.
And so, yeah, it's weird. And so she's beating up. She's going around and she's beating up dudes. Like, she's pushing herself to the limits. And there's this part where there's these dudes that are dressed as Batman. And Batman, like, I'm so conflicted about this because Batman, we see something that we don't see of Batman very often.
Compassion.
But it's something that does exist in him, but he doesn't do it because he's never in that position usually. And now he is.
Mm-hmm.
He's forced into it. And he shows that same side of himself that, like, how did you deal with me, Alfred? And... He's like,
well, you kind of dress up as a bat and go out every night.
And, he's like, so how do you think I dealt with it? And he's like, point taken. Okay, well then I need to
figure out a different approach. And he does. And it's a wildly erratic and probably, how do I put this? It's probably not a wise idea what he did.
And then the ending, and I'm like, what? Huh? I don't know, man.
The Waller thing?
Yes.
Yeah, I didn't quite get that either.
I don't get it. I do not get it.
So, anyway, I actually would, skim it. That's what I think. I think it's a strong skim for this book. But, again, it's tying up the previous arc. And it's also going through and you know, trying to push something new and kind of hint at something new, as opposed to, you know, being an original story.
It's kind of
like filler in anime, you know? That's kind of what I would put this.
Yeah. What do you call filler in hentai? Isn't it kind of like until you get to the penetration, isn't it all filler?
Yeah, it's all filler. It's all fluff. It's all fluff.
Fluffing. They call it fluffing. Yeah, okay. Fluffing.
Anything risque, like pornography or hentai, that's fluffing, I imagine.
It's fluffing leading up to, okay.
Okay.
All right.
Anyway.
Had to clarify that. Had to. This book, I'm so conflicted about this. It's frustrating.
I expect more out of a Batman title. Like, but the art is beautiful.
And then it's... The thing is like, it does one thing the whole way through, and then at the end it does something completely different. And I'm like, it does not work.
No.
Like, if they would have started with what they ended with, super way to start the next issue, I think, you know? But it does not... That whole thing does not make me want to pick up the next issue. This issue does not make me want to pick up the next issue.
No.
I am really upset that I had ordered this already because I'm like, I don't want it. I didn't want to read it. I've been doing this thing lately where I put the books that I want to read the least at the beginning so that when I'm like, have read like 10 books, I'm at the best of the best.
Yep.
And I'm like, I want to keep reading because it's the best stuff. Whereas when you're all excited about it, you know, at first, you go like, okay, this is kind of a drudgery. That's what it was. I don't know. I mean, visually, it's not bad, and there's inklings of some good stuff, but I just feel like they focus on odd. Like, it's just odd, too. It's just...
I don't know. The pacing of the book is just really not well done. But again, the art's just amazing. I mean, I'll say the art is just fantastic, though.
I'm going to give it a weak skim.
I say strong skin for me because, again, yeah, I think the art was just worth it, but I don't think you should buy it.
All right, cool.
So we have, what, Aquaman number... What is it?
Hombre de Agua número 6.
Written by Dan Abnett. Brad Walker is the pencils. Andrew Hennessy is the inker. And Gabe El Taib.
As colorist.
Yes. And we pick up exactly where we left off on the last issue, where Supes is there trying to stop up the fight between the, I guess it's the United States Army, and Aquaman and Mera. And he's like, yeah, why are you fighting here? And they kind of get it personal, hey, and there's an army of Atlantean soldiers coming to invade. They're attacking.
Yeah, it's happening. Their king is being attacked by another country's military.
Yeah, duh. What do you think's going to happen?
I mean, if I was beating up Putin, you know, would they do?
The Russians would whoop your tail. They'd send Natasha after you, and you'd be murked already.
Yes, exactly.
Or even that new team, the Guardians. Have you seen that trailer?
Oh, I have seen that. It looks pretty neat, sick, man. For it Russian does team. Look pretty sweet.
Anyway, yeah. Off topic. Anyway. But yeah, there's an invasion force going in.
And they duke it out. I love this fight because it shows Aquaman. That Aquaman can go toe-to-toe with Superman.
And not just talk the fish.
Yes. And he's not a joke. And I love how Mira, she gets in there too, and she gives him, it's, you know. I was just hoping that she was going to, like, dehydrate the hell out of Superman, you know? And we would get, like, the Skeletor-looking Superman, kind of.
Skeletor Superman.
Where he's just, like, super dehydrated. Like, you know how he looked? Well, didn't they do it in Batman v Superman where he was all, like, cheek-sunken in and he looked, like, all Skeletor and stuff?
No, but they did that in the Flashpoint Paradox when he was all skinny and stuff.
Oh, yeah, no, but I'm talking about, like, when they hit him with that nuke in Dark Knight Returns.
You mean in Man of Steel?
Was that Man of Steel?
Yeah.
But anyway. Then there's the other stuff that is the Black Manta, African American Manta, and he's like taking over this
Black Atlantean Manta.
Yeah.
He's not American.
He's not?
No. I don't even. Well, it's not really said what nationality is he. And he actually seems human, to tell you
so
the truth.
So he just took over. And, yeah, they haven't, like, clarified. But anyways.
But it's a beautiful book.
This was way better, I think, than the previous issues. I really liked how it was, like, just the way... I just thought it was so well done, this fight with him and Aquaman. The words that they exchange and the fight itself.
And the colors.
Visually, all of it. Yeah, everything about it looks really great. I really liked... And they did say, oh, yeah, well, you're considered a terrorist, so it negates these certain laws, and that's why we're dealing with you this way. Okay, I still think it's bull, but you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, and it was great how he was like, I'm going to do this. So, it's a strong, well...
I'm going to give it a strong buy.
Yeah, it's a strong buy.
I wouldn't give it a contender.
Yeah, exactly.
But, well,
not
a
contender,
strong,
but it is a strong buy. So, for sure.
And then we have a book, another book that I did not pick up.
You didn't pick it up, huh?
No, I did not pick up Green Arrow number, right. What, 6?
Hit that timer when I'm ready. Okay, it is Green Arrow number 6 with Benjamin Percy's story, Stephen Byrne as art and color. Cool?
Sure.
Hit it. All right, so this one, different art, and that's because it's from the point of view and the narration is through Amiko and how she, it's her own story. It's like almost complete departure. Like, it does bring up some stuff of the current, you know,
mm-hmm.
So it does move that just a teeny bit with her and her mom. And then she finds out that, like, her and her mom's, like, still working for the Yakuza. And that the Yakuza was just kind of planning on taking over for the Ninth Circle, or that was their plan. But then she goes into, like, oh, yeah, I used to be, you know, when I was staying with Oliver, she got bored, and so she started to try to get in with a cool crowd, and ends up being the Clock King, or whatever.
Yeah, she starts smoking. The cool kids, yeah.
Yeah, it was actually really cool, dude. Like, I thought that... I've always thought, like, the Clock King is stupid. I hate these villains that are a complete joke, but I love it when they do stuff like this, and they go, hey, we're going to try something completely different, and it was freaking awesome.
So, when it comes down to the Clock King, did they make him more similar to what he was, like, on Era, or, like, what he was on Batman the Animated Series?
I don't know how he was on Batman. I don't remember how he was on Batman the Animated Series, but I'm pretty sure he wasn't like the Clock King from Arrow, because
no.
This kind of goes into more of like a mystical type of thing, because it's like he has the power to, like, he gives the watch to these people and they can slow down time.
Yeah, that's one of the plot devices they used in Batman the Animated Series.
So, but the thing is that you have to do these tasks for him, like rob banks and stuff like that. Otherwise, he will, like, slow down. He'll do it. He'll, like, speed your life up so that you age fast if you don't do these things for him. So I'm like, whoa, that's nuts.
That's pretty brutal.
Like, it's cool, dude. It is cool. So I give it a strong buy. I love the feel of it. I feel like the softer, or not softer, but just, like, the more cartoony, I guess. And it did look like kind of like a three, kind of like a, that same look too, I would even say. Like that Batman animated look sort of to the art.
I mean,
you
pick that up after the show. And
so, I give it a strong buy. And I'm down for the next one. I want to see how her little adventure continues, if it continues, which I hope it does in the next issue. So, yeah.
So, strong buy, is it a contender or is it not a contender?
Not quite a contender.
Okay. Well, I have one that you did not pick up, and that was Justice League number 4, written by Brian Hitch, penciled by Jesus Marino, and ink by Andy Owens and Jesus Marino. Colors by Tumi Mori, or Tumeo, whatever his name is.
Tumi Mori?
Yeah. Anyway, so we have the Lanterns, you know, the two Green Lanterns of Earth, which are... You know, Cruz and what's Simon's last name? Bias or Balls? Whatever his name. Anyway, they're protecting the space. They're fighting these monsters out in space. And then we have Cyborg and Batman and you know, Lois and Jonathan kind of trying to survive these little winged creatures that look like hell and whatnot. It's just crazy. Superman is still in the Earth from last issue because they sent him into the core to blow up some sort of bombs that were in there. And Flash and Wonder Woman come across the little four beings. I mean, everybody's just trying to help out where they can. And it is just chaos. And then it shows Superman's struggle against, you know, what he was trying to do for his mission. And Batman's distrust of how he's not going to really, you know, solve it. But it's building to a very big plot point. I mean, this all this comic is. It's building. It's building. It's building. And it's like, okay, where do we go from here? And it's basically just ends. Let me try and get to the ending real quick. Yeah, you know, Wonder Woman's trying to help out Barry real quick, and then Batman's trying to come up with a secondary plan and can't. I mean, it's just... And then there's like an army of like cyborg people with like holes in their chest. I don't quite get that. But yeah, it's really, really strange. This is an odd book, but it's very visually stunning. It doesn't slow down. It is non-stop. So... if you want action, this is where you go. This should be Action Comics instead of Justice League. So this is a strong buy. This is not a contender, but it is a strong buy for me.
Okay, cool. Right on. All right, sweetness. You ready for Superman number 6?
Yes, Superman.
All right, Peter J. Tomasi and Patrick Gleason as the story, and then Patrick Gleason as the penciler, Mick Gray as the inker, John Calise is the colorist.
Did you lose your lucky charms?
Oh, never. They're magically delicious. So this continues this onslaught of Eradicator. And
last
I'm kind of like, I'm done. Like, I'm like, come on, let's wrap this up, this Eradicator, because it's just more
it's
and more.
Dragging out.
Now, this is more him. And they do, like, I would say, the crypto, that was cool.
Yeah.
I like the wolf-looking crypto, though, versus the dog-looking crypto.
And I grew up on the crypto, you know, and this, well, I grew up on the superpowers.
Yeah.
And crypto wasn't really part of the superpowers. He was part of the super friends, but not a part of the superpowers.
To me, I like the idea of, like, crypto looking more like a wolf, because I like the idea that crypto is legitimately like from, he's like a creature from
Krypton,
yeah, and
to...
not just a dog that has powers.
Yeah.
Like a what kind of dog is he?
A white one?
Retriever?
A white retriever?
A white retriever?
If there's such a thing.
Yeah. So, but it does come to fruition, and it's really awesome. It's really cool. It's really great. And, you know, it's
a lot of character development.
Yeah, it's really great. There's so many great moments in this. This is the ultimate issue, I feel, where they go, Superman is back.
Yep.
Not just the one from, but like the original.
Yeah.
Is back.
The real Superman.
And now what is also back is a legitimate Superboy.
Yes. Because they do name Jonathan Kent. I guess this is his name, Jonathan Kent.
Yeah.
Superboy from this point. So we have, what, three? We have Connor, we have Jonathan, and now we have, what, Mon-El are taking the name of Superboy. But then again, we have, like, what, three Superman? We have the new Superman, this one, and then post-52. Yeah, the new 52.
So, this I don't head. Know. I can't follow. I like the original Superboy.
Well, the original Superboy was Superman.
Superman as
young,
a boy,
yeah.
No, but I mean the original. Well, I
talking about the one with the shades and the leather jacket and stuff?
Yes, I love that look.
The motorcycle look?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, that's the one I like the most. So, but I also, actually, I really like the one that's from Young Justice as well.
Yep, the Connor Kent.
Which is kind of, which is the same basis, right? Sort
and they're
of
both
like they were
clones.
Made. Well, they're both clones. From, not
Lexi.
Star Labs,
Cadmus.
Cadmus, yes. They're both clones of Superman and Cadmus. What I don't understand, though, is, like, why is it that, like, Eradicator and Superboy, and I think even, Cyborg Superman, all their blasts don't come from their eyes.
Yeah, they come from their hands, I believe.
Yeah.
Except for Superboy, he was telekinetic at that time. He was mostly telekinesis.
Oh, really?
Mostly.
So, but...
Anyway, that was back in the day.
Yeah.
But for this book...
This one's strong by... Yeah, this was really amazing.
Yes.
Like I said, when I got into it, I was like, oh, not more Eradicator. But as it went on, it just kept getting better and better and better. So, it's
a great finale.
Awesome. Yeah, strong by.
So...
Definitely.
Strong by, contender for me.
Okay. On to...
Nightwing in it.
It's Nightwing number 4. Tim Seeley as the writer. Then we have, I want to say, Javier Fernandez as the artist, as the main artist.
And Chris.
And then Chris Sotomayor as colors, right?
Yep.
So this one, it's one of those things where it's gone too far. And the thing is, the Owls put him in this position and, you know, on purpose.
Yeah.
Him and Raptor, where they're like, okay, we're going to throw these peasants or whatever, these people into some cages, and we're going to throw you all into a labyrinth. And with this, like...
Beast,
owl, were-owl creature. Yeah, it's...
Man-owl.
Yeah.
There we go.
It's pretty...
We coined it Man-owl.
So, it's pretty crazy. And I would have to say, though, my favorite is... I mean, just this team-up. This team-up is so great of Raptor watching Nightwing's back, Nightwing watches Raptor's back.
And they both don't trust each other still.
And, but I, my favorite, my absolutely favorite part, Nightwing goes, I know you're in the circus. I know it. There's, because you knew about these things, and just the way you do this.
It's the detective in Dick.
Yes. The detective in Dick, yes.
Or is it the Dick in the detective? How does that work?
So, I don't know. I was kind of disappointed that they are not continuing this Court of Owls thing. But...
Maybe getting a well-deserved break from the Court of Owls to kind of develop the Raptor character a little bit more.
But, and yeah, like, that's something is they say is, oh, that's done with, but it's not. But there's a branch off from it, so... That's definitely going to be looked into more as the Raptor character. I'm definitely willing to... I mean, I definitely want to find out more about this guy, for sure.
Yeah, and we will. I imagine this will be a plot point for many issues to come.
Yeah, definitely. So, and I kind of... Yeah, man, I don't know. I was just... The thing I was most looking forward to is seeing if they could destroy the trust...
Between the two characters?
Between Damian and...
Oh, and Dick?
And Dick.
Yeah.
Especially for Batman, too. Like, that would have been cool to have, like, the Owls. You know what I mean? Kind of what happened with Babs, where she thought that guy was dead, but he wasn't actually dead, but it looked like he was dead, so it was still pretty bad, you know? So, yeah. I don't know. We'll see where it goes. It's one of those things where I'm still very much looking forward to the next issue.
Yep.
So I give it a strong buy and a contender.
All agree. Strong buy and contender for Dick this week. So that was our Dick pick. Oh, show him a Dick pick.
Oh, what?
Yeah, show him a Dick pick.
Which one? There's so many.
The one in the front works.
The front cover?
Yeah. See? It's a Dick pick.
Yep, it is.
So the next we have Cyborg Rebirth. Number one.
Yes.
Written by John Semper Jr. Paul Pelletier is doing pencils. Sandra Hope and Tony Cordos is doing inks. And colors is done by Guy Major. And wow. We jump into the fire as soon as we open the first page.
Yes. Cyborg is fighting like this nanotech giant monster creature.
That calls himself Malware of all things. Malware.
And it's, I don't know, this, it's a very wordy book.
Yes.
And there's kind of multiple...
Voices, like...
Narratives, yeah.
It's like you have the computer talking, you have something that calls Cyborg or Victor Patient Zero or...
Subject Zero.
Subject Zero, yeah. And then you have, like, the narration and retelling of his past, you know, his family upbringing, more about Silas Stone, how he became Cyborg, But it's all happening every time that he gets knocked out for like 15 seconds during the fight with Malware.
Yes.
So during this 15 seconds, he's doing this remembering what's going on. And, you know, and then we get back to the story. So it's kind of a good breakup of the fight.
It is. Like I said, it is pretty wordy. Now, but not horribly, though. Definitely not horribly. And it's really interesting. So, and I feel like most of it is just, I don't know, it's cool because it's like this brand new story, but it's also the origins of...
this cyborg.
Of Victor Stone. And then they get to the end and they bring up an idea, which is there actually where even Silas doesn't know if his son is in there or just like a replica of him.
Or even like a robot with a pretend soul. I mean, what is Cyborg? Is he still Victor? Is he all the machine? Or is he all the machine trying to pretend to be Victor? I mean, nobody really knows. It's unconfirmed and unused technology. Very, very new stuff. Untested. Experimental. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. But the comic in total, this is a strong buy and a contender for me. I'm not a huge Cyborg fan, but I like this. This art style, the storytelling, the diverse character itself, this is what I'm looking for in a comic. So, strong buy contender for me.
I would... okay, as a rebirth, because I feel like this is what a rebirth is supposed to do.
Yeah.
With, like, intro to their character. Now, if you were reading the previous Cyborg, I don't feel like you need...
I was not.
...the first half of this book, necessarily. Or, I mean, you do, except for the stuff that's new.
Yeah, because...
So there is that. But... and it was kind of wordy. But... I don't know. It's... it was still very solid, though. So, I will say it's a strong buy. Definitely. I think the first issue is going to be better.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Because we get to find out who...
this is what a rebirth is supposed to be.
It's supposed to be an introduction to the character if you haven't been picking up the book. And for me, I haven't been picking up the book, so it's a great introduction for me. Next, we have Supergirl, number 1.
Yes!
Wow. I was surprised by this book.
Pleasantly?
Pleasantly surprised by this book. The credits are at the end. Colors are, excuse me, they're written by Steve Orlando, art by Brian Ching, colors by Michael Ataya? Ataya, yeah, there we go. I'll let you do that, Ataya. And I'm not going to even reveal to them the name of this title of this book because it totally spoils the ending.
They brought it up, though, at the end of... yeah, I wouldn't, but they showed it at the end of Rebirth, if you read that. But yeah, this one, now this for me is way better.
Yes, than the Rebirth.
Way better than the Rebirth. Now, I'm not saying it was bad, but I'm saying this is what I wanted out of the... but this is the number one.
Yeah.
So this kind of is more... I don't know, this is more of what I wanted out of Rebirth,
yeah.
But this is perfect for a number one. Like,
yep.
This is perfect. This is, it's her in high school, it's her being normal.
Her being Supergirl for the first few times.
And it's showing how she was in Krypton, which I love. It was like, I love the Krypton stuff. Like, how it kept on flashing back, she was like, I was so good in science, and now I'm treated like I'm an idiot here, because this stuff is so...
Primitive,
yeah, it's so old school. And then they even have Cat Grant, which that was interesting, how they have her in there. And just how she's kind of like an agent now, you know?
Yeah, she's an agent of the...
yeah, and she's not like Superman, where she's on her own.
She's still learning, and she's only been on Earth for a few months, evidently, according to what's going on here.
Right.
So she's still trying to get used to her powers.
Right, she doesn't even... And that's what's funny, is like her... foster family, which are agents, they're like, they try to learn Kryptonian and they try to set up the house, and she's like, these are really old records of how the houses used to look, and your Kryptonian's pretty rough, you know?
Yeah.
And they're trying, though.
Yeah, they're making the effort, you know, they're doing
well. And I love how they're like, well, there's not a manual on this stuff, and I'm like, There's a manual on parenting, but there's not a manual on parenting a girl from Krypton.
Yeah, that's got super strength, heat vision, breath, invulnerability, flight. Yeah.
And then she goes hormones. Yeah, it's... I'm super excited for this book. Like, this is everything that I want and hope for in a Supergirl book. Like,
yes. At the end, they bring in to the cyborg Superman, who claims to be, what, not Jor-El, but was Jor-El's brother that was her father of, crap. Trivia. That's your trivia question for today.
Is it?
Name Jor-El's brother and, Kara... It's his name, Zor-El. Kara Zor-El. Okay. That was her name. Well, I took that. Never mind. No trivia. Sorry. But anyway, his name is Zor-El. And he is the new cyborg Superman, evidently.
Okay.
So, yeah.
I like it. I like these things where there's it's stronger ties to...
Familia.
Yes. Like, that's why I didn't mind when they kind of did that... Like in the, what was it? The Earth One comic book series, the graphic novels.
Yeah.
How Zod is like the cousin of
Jor-El.
Or uncle or something like that of Superman.
Yeah.
So.
Keeping it all in the family.
Yeah, I like it. But anyways.
Strong buy.
Strong buy, definitely.
Contender.
I give it a contender without a doubt.
Yes.
It was a killer
strong book.
Last book of the week, it is Skyborn. It's published by Boom Studios. It's created, written, and illustrated by Frank Cho, colored by Marcio Menz. And so you just see this dude, and he's fallen from the sky, and he lands, and he creates like a crater, and then he's like, ah, shit. And then it just changes to these military dudes. This chick's like, hey, I'm here to negotiate this thing about this item that we, you know, my company procured from you, like bought, and why won't you give it up? And he's like, well, because we found out that there's more to it than that. So he goes on the run, and she's just killing these dudes, like bare hands, dude, like through the chest.
Dang.
Or to the back, you know, like out the back. Like, it's just crazy. And it turns out this sword is Excalibur.
Ooh.
And so they get this sword, and then just this old dude with a staff is in the middle of the road, and he's like, you shall not pass! He doesn't say that, but he pulls that type of thing and, like, slams it, you know, and wrecks him. And they have a fight. It's crazy. It looks amazing. I mean, it's Frank Cho. And, you know, that's I always love these types of series where you have an artist that creates, writes, illustrates, but...
Or you have one
like,
creative force.
Yes. Because then that person...
They have
person,
that one vision.
That
and
one
that
vision.
Stray.
Yes, exactly. And it's issue number 1 of 5. So it's one of those things where, hey, you're in for 5 issues. You know, it's a limited series. I miss, like... That's something I've noticed. They don't really put that on comics anymore.
No, the 1 of 5 or 1 of...
Like, they used to put, like, LS or limited series. Yeah, 1 of 5 or whatever. They don't do that anymore. They should because you know what that makes me go? Hey, I don't mind.
Picking up a couple issues. If I don't like it, I'll stop. If I do, I'll pick up the whole thing.
In fact, even if they would put, like, hey, this is issue 1 of 5 for this story arc, it'd be like, okay, this story arc's only this long.
Yeah.
I'll be down. I'm down for this story arc.
I'm down for, like, 5 issues of a story arc. I'm down for 7 issues of a story arc.
Yeah.
And then you can go, okay, I didn't like this story arc, so I can just pick up this 7 issues later.
Right, because when you know that arc's over and the next graphic novel's going to start at this one, you can go, okay, now I can start picking it up at trade or whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That type of thing. Anyways, with that, I mean, you could get it in trade, or you could get it in issues. Really great, really interesting. That's one thing that I will have to say is with an artist creative team like this, the art is the basis. So it's not wordy at all. It's mostly the art that tells the story. And it looks gorgeous. And I'm not just talking about the women. You know?
Yeah.
Even though that usually is
The one of the highlights.
For Frank Cho's art. But yeah, Strong Buy, boom, that's it. There it is.
So, we get to our runner-up and back and bag of the week for each of us this week.
It's time.
So, for me, JD, my runner-up for back and bag of the week for the week of September the 7th, 2016, is All New, All Different Adventures number 14, The Wasp and... Wasp, I guess they're both wasps. The wisps. That whole storyline, it hit me in the feels. It was perfect. It just made me want to see more of those two characters and have more character development for them. So, yeah, Marvel, you did great on that. Great timing. You teased out the next issue of Civil War proper. You know. And now I want to go see that. I want to see the fight now. So, it's really wanting to see Civil War number 5, I think is what it is. All right, the next one. So, that was my runner-up. My back and bag of the week is Supergirl number 1. That's by far what I thought was the best book visually, story-wise, and had great character development. If I was like 19 or something, I could relate a little bit more to the character or whatnot. But I'm not that young anymore. But still, I was able to relate, you know, remembering my youth and whatnot, and relate to the character.
I see myself as 19 forever. So, or at least now, you know, I feel like I can pull it off.
I could feel like I was
19. People say that I look young. And especially when I don't have the flavor saver, then I definitely look young. I look even younger, I feel like, than 19.
See, the hair makes me, hey, I got some age on this hair.
I don't know. That long hair, I feel like that's not, you know.
It takes a long time to grow.
But yeah, that's true. That is true.
So anyway, your back in bags of the week. What's your runner-up for the week, bud?
Okay,
somebody good than what she's from.
Nightwing is super great, but I'm going to have to go with Supergirl as my runner-up. It was just exactly what I want out of Supergirl. Exactly. Like 100%.
Yep.
It's what I was hoping for the Rebirth, didn't get, and now I got it.
I hope the TV show goes in this direction.
They won't, and the reason they won't is because they pulled... And that's why I don't like that they did this in the show, which is... They had Kara show up as a young girl, you know, even though she's like 10 or whatever when
and
she
she's
showed up.
Like 20s and they're like 22 maybe.
And right when she actually showed up is like she's a teenager, and I like that better because it's like, well, she would legitimately have a really hard time assimilating into our culture.
Being like a 15-year-old.
Yes, in high school because she has to learn a whole new language. Like she has to learn completely
English.
Different culture. American, you know, like
technology,
all that.
Cell phones.
You know, I wonder if there's like
etiquette.
An accent. Yeah, like everything, like manners, all that stuff. Yeah, the technology, all those things. She doesn't have that problem in the show, and that really irritates me that they don't have that.
But they don't kind of flashback, hey, this is how she learned.
Instead,
know?
They just made it into like, oh, she's just another Superman.
So question, how would Kara have done a Mac? You know, would she have, you know, struggled with a Mac?
What do you?
I mean,
what
like
are you
a Mac.
To say? Like
I mean,
a Macintosh.
Yeah, I mean, come on.
Like the old Macintosh,
yeah.
Or
like the big box one.
Well, even though it's still ahead of its time, so to speak, not anymore. They're going backwards now, and not just with their phones.
Personally, no comment.
So.
I know more than I should. I work for the company, so I can't say.
Yes, no
I can't
comment.
Say too much.
Yes, you shouldn't. So, but anyways, it's unfortunate that they haven't. No, I don't think she would be good with the technology.
Yeah.
And they show that in this.
Yeah.
Where like it's so primitive, you know, even the high tech stuff.
It'd be like people now using an abacus.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not sure if you know what an abacus is or not, viewers. Yeah, abacus is basically
a
sundial, row of beads,
you know,
and you use beads to count off numbers, and it's basically an ancient calculator, more or less.
Anal beads?
No, not anal beads.
No?
No.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We know how to use those now, though.
Some people do. Some people know how to use those.
um, Anyways,
your back and bag of the week.
My back
September
and bag.
7th.
I feel like there should be a cushion between me mentioning this because, you know, that leap of filth to this clean, just
wholesome,
you know, family friendly
apple pie style.
Yes,
stuff.
Book Spidey number 10 is my back and bag of the week. Had everything that I could want in a comic because, as okay, you know, I love Spidey, right?
Classic
I love
Spidey.
Classic Spidey, and then. Who else do I also love?
You got Cap.
I love Cap, man.
Well,
I love
not,
Cap.
Not Hydra Cap, but Cap.
Yes. Yeah. I like Capsicle, you know.
Yeah.
Like freshly thawed out, melted Capsicle.
Freshly microwaved.
And especially the street, you know, like the...
The street level.
The street level, yes.
So
I miss that so much.
Daredevil and Luke Cage doing
it. I kind of wish, and I've always thought that it would be cool to actually see him kind of like the U.S. agent stuff, which is boots on the ground with our troops. You know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. That's what I... And yes, there is a bigger villain there. Like, there is an Arnim Zola or there is a Red Skull that's leading those...
But the
evil armies.
Is the ground war.
Right, but it's him saving American lives. Or NATO, you know, like, other lives too. Not just... It's NATO missions. It wouldn't just be American lives, but... That's what I want to see. Like, man, I almost feel like...
We could write Captain American fan fiction.
No, I
that plot, yeah.
I honestly feel like I read so many comics at this point that... And they're comics that are not being made that I feel like I should just...
Start making them?
Write my own comics. You know what I mean? Like
copyright infringement?
There's a lot of... No, but I mean, like, no, I want to be a comic book writer and I just feel like, hey, they're not... They don't want that now, but maybe they want that...
In about 3 years?
10 years, you know. Whatever, yeah. However many years down the road, maybe that's what they want when my work is refined and I have, like, this planned out...
This vision.
...story arc of, like, hey, this is what I wanted to do as a Cap, you know, story. This is what I want my X-Men team to be. This is what... I would love to see an X-Men team where it's legitimately led by a young, non-crippled Xavier.
Say, by James McAvoy.
So, yeah.
Okay, so you're going to get
your... But have him do it with, like, a more... But with new X-Men.
Okay, so...
Not the original X-Men, but with new X-Men.
Okay. Nobody that's established, just brand new team.
I mean, there could be established people, like, coming in and out, but they're old at that point.
Like the all-new, all-different Wolverine?
Like the original. Yeah, like something like that. Like other characters, too. You know.
Bring back Warlock.
Like my own. I would like to bring in my own... X-Men.
Like, so, Pablo Gunner's New Mutants.
Yeah, New Mutants. Yeah, for sure. New Mutants and have it be...
Xavier,
you know,
reincarnated.
Xavier's own team. But I want him to be an international... I miss when X-Men used to be an international team, though,
yeah.
Too. Remember, we got... There was the Russian, which was...
Colossus. You had the African, which was Storm.
Yes.
The Canadian, or Australian at the time, but Canadian... Wolverine.
Yes.
You had the German Nightcrawler.
Yes.
You had the Native American, what was it, Thunderbird? Or wait, was it Thunderbird?
No, it
John,
was
Proudstar. It was Proudstar, but it was John.
But there were Warpath, too. He was
Warpath.
Native American.
That was it. Warpath.
Warpath was freaking... I love Warpath.
His name is like John Proudstar or something like that.
And
there was one more. What's in there?
But there was other Canadians. I know that the...
We had Alpha Flight.
There's the Alpha Flight. There's a couple. The ones that have the super lights or whatever.
Is there
Northstar? The brother. Yeah, Northstar. He was part of the team, too. And he was... But anyways, like, I want a Latino. I want a Latino, like, South American.
Like X-Men. Starfire?
Yes.
Like, not Starfire, but Sunfire.
Sunspot.
Sunfire was,
I think.
The Japanese on that team.
Yeah.
Or the Asian, excuse me. Even though
he was on the team for a little while, and then he left. He was part
then
of the
team. Then he became
young
a villain for Big Hero 6 there for a minute or whatever. Yeah, I've been lost.
Yeah, he's gone in and out. But, yeah, man, I want it more international. I feel like they're all...
American.
And you know what's something that's missing? They don't write them that way anymore either.
No, they're all...
Like, I love it when you used to read a comic, and you had to read it in their accent. You know what I mean? Like, now they just put it regular English... And you just have to think it in your head, their accent. I liked it when you would read it, and there was no way you could read it without saying it in your head.
There was one book that I read this week, and it had the Russian, And it was that veal. I think it was the Moon Knight, where it had the Russian in it, and it was like he starts with the V's instead of the W's. Yes. And it was perfect. You could enunciate it like that, and it would sound like you're speaking Russian.
And, yeah. And, I mean, even though it was a little over the top,
it gave the effect.
Like, even if you're just still, like, with Canadians, you're making them say a boot all the time. Like, it would still be funny.
Eh?
Yeah, eh? Yeah. You want to go get some food, eh? I don't know.
Some poutine gravy.
Yeah.
Some poutine gravy.
There you go. I don't know. I don't know these things. I'd have to... I wouldn't, yeah.
Yeah, you gotta go to Canada sometime. It's pretty good. It's pretty nice. I've been there a couple times.
Okay, cool. Yeah. I've met a few Canadians before, and they were nice folks. They're really friendly.
I wouldn't mind going either Montreal or Toronto.
The ladies are really pretty, so...
Yeah, I wouldn't mind going on to Montreal, Toronto, especially Toronto, since they do a lot of filming there. And, you know, it'd be great to see some of the good filming that they have going on up there.
Interesting. Like I said, the Canadian ladies were friendly and attractive. Didn't feel like that gave me the right to rape them. Weird, right?
Yeah, really.
Odd. Really, really weird. You know? It wasn't like, hey, she's really friendly.
And she's hot.
Yeah.
Nah.
No, does that make her slutty? That thought never crossed my mind. Is that weird?
No, it's not weird.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
All right.
You always
look
at the menu.
So I don't know what's going on with the peeps on the stuff.
Yeah, we've been we finished our nice little comic book review of the week. So we're just gonna BS around for a few minutes and kind of talk shop about stuff that we've heard in the last little bit. And if you want to keep watching the show, keep watching the show. If you want to check out the reviews, hit the rewind button. And always definitely like, comment, subscribe. Check us out on social media, Facebook community, yeah, all that good stuff. So let's continue and have nice discussions. We haven't talked about television series in a while, and that stuff's coming up in about a month.
They're going to start, yeah.
They're going to start with the CW stuff, the DC superheroes. You're going to start up with Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. soon. What else are we going to start up with? We're going to have Ash versus the Evil Dead, which I'm...
I'm going to plug in my control, my PS4 control, because I want to play some Overwatch tonight, which is free on the PSN.
I have not downloaded it, so I don't know.
So I want to make sure my cord is nice and charged for that.
I checked out the Titanfall beta, and that was pretty good.
So... Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm. Neat. That looks cool, man. Like, I'll say the first one did not look very... like, impressive to me, especially because, what did they do?
Made it exclusive to Xbox.
They made it, did they make it exclusive to Xbox?
Yes, it was.
But beyond that, it was only online multiplayer, wasn't it?
I'm not sure. Again, I
there
don't
was
have
no
any...
single story for it to it, so.
And episode 2 for the Batman Telltale series comes out later this month. I believe it's on the 20th, somewhere around there.
Oh, yeah. And I still have to get the first one. I still have to get it.
You've got to get that. It is so good. I think I've played it another 3 more times since the last time I spoke with you. I mean, that's... You can be like a total dick to people in that game. Like, Carmine Falcone comes into the game.
Yeah.
Spoilers. Carmine Falcone comes into the game. And you can be a total ass to him. He's like, you can shake his hand. Or you can snap it away. Or, kind of ignore him and say, I ain't going to shake your hand. You're a criminal. I'm around all these rich people. They don't need to see me shaking your hand. And you can play it cool. And if somebody discovers your secret identity, you can go, yeah, you're right. Or, I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Yeah,
it's choose your own adventure for Batman, and man, it's gonna be great. I'm still excited about the new Spider-Man game, though.
That looks so cool.
That's something I really want to check out.
It looks so amazing. I love games. Well, I love Spider-Man games. They're just so great.
Hold on, idea: $1 million comic book video game idea, Spider-Verse, but as a massive online multiplayer game. So check it out. You get to be whatever the hell Spider-Man you want, including creating your own Spider-Man. I get to be whatever hell Spider-Man I want, creating my own Spider-Man. We go out into the city, Manhattan, New York City, whatever, and we can interact and do missions together. And save the multiverse or the Spider-Verse. $1 million idea. Make it.
I don't think it's the kind of idea that would work yet. I think like in a few years it would be gold.
But especially if it was cross-platform.
Because the Spider-Verse is something that's kind of new-ish even, you know.
Well, I mean, so is this new Spider-Man suit that they have on for the video game
with
now.
The white, yeah.
Yeah, that's kind of really weird.
They're just changing things up, I think, you know. I like it.
I mean, it'd be a way to make money.
So.
So what else have you been playing on the games?
So there was I have not been playing much, so I can't really. I do intend on playing some Ratchet & Clank. I borrowed that from gamers.
Nice.
So.
Well, I've been wanting to play that too. I have a couple of the Ratchet & Clanks for the PS3 and for the PS2.
It's the PS4 one. It's a brand new one. So, once again, proof that they don't just carry.
Is that the one the movie's based off of? Or
yeah, it is.
Okay.
Yeah. So, you were talking about shows.
But yeah, shows. Okay. Anyway. So, we have Supergirl, Flash, Arrow, and Legends of Tomorrow coming up. And they've added so many new announcements for each of these shows. They've been filming and started releasing trailers. I mean, if you haven't caught up and you need some catch up, now's a good time to do it. You have about a month left before all these shows hit and start, you know, blowing your mind on, you know, how connected they are, the cohesive story arcs. I mean, they are really hyping the seasons. And then Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is going to be adding Ghost Rider. Yes. Or not, you know, Johnny Blaze or Dan Ketch. But Ronnie, what's his name? Ronnie Reyes, I believe? Ronnie Reyes. Or
Robbie.
Robbie Reyes.
I think it's Robbie.
So, yeah. He's got his awesome Camaro-ish looking car. And it looks pretty sick. And I haven't heard too much about it. They've been really keeping it hush-hush. All the actors have been kind of staying off of social media and not really trying to spoil it. But, yeah.
So going live on Facebook.
Going live on Facebook. And
with our page. Just on me, though. I mean, we all know that's what they really want
to
see.
Oh, they really want to see Pablo here.
I mean, yeah. They want to see the goods.
I mean, I'm
right there.
Yeah, the goods. And then we have the Ustream up.
Yeah.
See, nobody wants to see this Carolina boy. I mean, nobody.
What?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's right.
Oh.
Carolina boy.
There we go.
That's right.
The Bulls.
Not the Bulls. The Heels.
I know it's not the Bulls, but I mean.
The Bears.
The Bulls, you know, greatest player. And just greatest player, period.
Oh, yeah. Michael Jordan came out there. Even a guy from my hometown, Jerry Stackhouse, he went from playing in my hometown at the high school, going to UNC and playing there, and then going up to the 76ers there for a bit. I don't know what he's doing anymore.
Cool.
Jerry Stackhouse was the player's name. So
nice.
Back to shows and stuff. What else? We're going to have probably another season of Preacher coming out soon.
I heard it got better, but it because of the huge departure from the book, it just irritated me to the point where I was like, screw this noise. Like, I can't stand it. It's too much for me. I don't know. Here's the thing. Like, okay, as far as Flash goes,
we know we're starting in Flashpoint.
Flashpoint.
Episode 1 of Season 3 is entitled Flashpoint.
I just want Flashpoint to be.
I want it to be a five or six episode arc and be done. Then we go back to normal. And then we see changes because of Flashpoint.
Yeah, like, that seems fair. Like, five. But I want it to be where it changes all the other shows except for, like, Legends of Tomorrow.
Yeah, because they're kind of stuck between the time stream.
Right. Even if theirs was messed up, I'd be fine with that. And they're like, but they leave it, so it wouldn't matter, kind of, you know?
What if the Legends meet up with Barry and goes, hey, you screwed this up. We got to go fix this. What would you think about that?
That would be interesting, but I know that's not their, like, mission or whatever. Like, they're fighting, the Legion of Doom on their own?
Yeah, that's what
which
they...
Which is, it's their own Legion of Doom. It's not the actual Legion of Doom.
Yeah.
It's,
The Reverse Flash, Damian Dark, Malcolm Merlyn, and Captain Cold, so far. As the four villains that they've announced as the Legion of Doom.
Okay, that's pretty sweet. So, but I just wanted to see, for one, I wanted to see Arrow get reset. But even more so than that, I wanted to see Old Man.
You wanted to see Robert Queen.
I want to see Robert Queen as
the vigilante.
As Arrow, but
with guns.
But with guns, which I guess wouldn't make sense for him to be called
Arrow.
Arrow, but I mean, you could still call the show Arrow, but I think it would be like they wouldn't call him Gun or Guns. But
yeah.
I mean, because even then, like when you think about it, he didn't go by Arrow or Green Arrow for the longest time. Not
he was
until
just
like
the vigilante,
most recent.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was just the vigilante. And he, like, straight up killed mofos in the first season. Like, he killed a lot of people. And then the second one, it was, like, half. And then I think the third season, it was, like, maybe a third. And they've been dropping it less and less and less. I think, like, now it's only, like, one or two per season.
Yeah.
Which is really... I don't know. It makes sense with the character development. I just don't care. Like, the show's just not as good. And that's part of what... That's part of, like, my issue with it and why I want it. Because... My idea is, okay, do that stuff, which is essentially turn, you said Robert Queen, right?
Yeah,
Robert Queen into...
Thomas Wayne.
Into Thomas Wayne, and then have, so, and in doing so, have Thomas Wayne
help
Barry get his powers back, and then...
Well, he's not going to lose
And then change
powers.
Things back. I know he's not losing his powers, but I think they should have. That would make it even better, I think.
It's like, how do you fix this when you can't?
Right. It's like... Well, right. How do you fix it when you can't? So if he can, why wouldn't he?
Yeah.
That just doesn't make sense to me. So, anyways.
So they're adding a few new characters to it. They're adding Artemis. They're adding Wild Dog. And they're adding Mr. Terrific.
Like, to
Arrow? Yes,
or
to Arrow.
I know, or to... Mr. Terrific I knew when they added that guy.
Yeah,
I was like,
he's
becomes,
actually going to have a T on his face and everything.
Mr. Terrific. I always thought that's like so stupid.
I've seen pictures of him with the T on his face.
I like the character of Mr. Terrific. I just hate the way that it looks. And then, of course, we've also seen what's his name as
Spartan.
But no, I mean, I'm thinking of Kid Flash. He looks.
Yeah, we've
super
seen Kid
cool.
Flash. Yeah, Wally's Kid Flash.
Yeah, Wally's Kid Flash looks really awesome.
Oh yeah.
So.
And then the guy that they're facing is called the Rival, evidently. And instead of Savitar.
I actually think that Barry is going to be the villain for the entire arc of
Flashpoint.
Because he even has, what's his name, imprisoned.
Yeah, he's got, evidently according to some of the promo images and trailers, he releases him at that point at behest of probably Iris. Iris convinces him to let the Reverse Flash free.
So, yeah, it's interesting. But... I don't know. I don't like this idea either of Superman at all.
Superman on Supergirl. So hold on. We have the production moving from LA for first season to moving to Vancouver, British Columbia, you know, for the next season. Since it's a Berlanti group, it's on the CW. You know, it'll save time, money, cost. It'll make it where it's more cohesive and easier to kind of cross over with other shows because. They're probably on the same lot, if not even like a quarter of a mile away from each other filming.
Yeah.
So does that mean we'll end up getting Superman on The Flash eventually? Or will we have Cisco kind of geek out over Supergirl and try and get her number?
I think it's just a giant monstrous mistake to have Superman. Because I like the idea that it may have been a crossover with the new DC with the DC
extended
EU,
yeah, EU is what they're
is
calling
that what it is the movie
yeah
universe?
The movie universe is called the EU DC expanded universe.
I liked that because you weren't sure, you know.
Well, we still can. Ezra Miller, who's the actor for The Flash, has hinted that Barry Allen from Gustin Grant, you know, the CW verse stuff, the Arrow Flyro verse, whatever you call it, may still exist. Within the movie timeline and within the movie reality, but on a different Earth. So he's hinted at that. He's even hinted at possibly meeting Gustin Grant. Or Grant Gustin.
That seems so weird.
That'd be really weird in
the movie. So they're just different universes then, is what you're saying.
Yeah. It'd be really weird in the movie that you see the Flash running as Ezra Miller, and then all of a sudden this other Flash runs beside him and it's Grant Gustin next to him, and then he looks over to the right again, and then there goes John Wesley Shipp as Barry Allen from the 90s Flash. And you just keep going down the road and there's like infinite Flashes running through the Speed Force at the same time, but they all look different.
Yeah.
That'd be really weird.
That is really weird.
But I mean,
I just, like I said, I don't like I've seen images too. I don't like the way the suit looks. I don't like the way the actor looks for the show. Like I just don't like the way.
Oh, for Superman, okay.
I feel like you're getting the great value version.
Yeah.
Essentially, because he's not like you. I mean, look at Henry Cavill. Like that guy.
He's built
huge.
I mean,
he is huge.
He's like 5 foot. I don't know.
He's monstrous.
He's like 5'11", I think.
Like he's just so ridiculously muscular, and that suit just looks so awesome. Now, okay, fine. He's a different universe, Superman. It's just a completely different universe. Period. Fine. But, like, really? I mean, because when you look at what's his name? Who plays Oliver?
Amell.
Stephen Amell. When you look at Stephen Amell, like, that guy is also freaking jacked, too. And so I go, if Stephen Amell can look that jacked, why can't
Superman.
Everybody else look that chiseled?
Especially
you know
the guy
I mean?
Playing Superman.
Especially the guy playing Superman, yes. So that's my biggest qualm with that for sure.
I don't know. And
but I am pretty excited to have Robbie Reyes as the new Ghost Rider. I saw his suit. I don't know. I really hope they do it. Like I want him to have an accent, you know, like a from East Los, you know, from East LA, like accent, hardcore. Like Chicano accent,
Barkay accent,
and then just like the look too. I want him to have the look and just the attitude and everything, you know.
Like it's all hard.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I get like he's a smart kid and stuff, and he's good at working on
vehicles
and stuff, and he's trying to do good in school, I really like the character because like his brother is crippled and he's in a wheelchair. And they can't afford it, so he, like, makes him a wheelchair and stuff. But he's also, like, trying to get him a legit wheelchair by making money. But he also wants to, like, get... Like, there's a lot of conflicting things there, you know, with that character. Like, he wants to get into college, you know, like, mechanical engineering and stuff. But, you know...
He can only do so much, you know.
Get involved with gangs, you know, because they're bad in his neighborhood and stuff. And, you know, all the cholos picking on him and stuff. You know what I mean? Like, I want to... see all that, but I know we're not going to get all that.
Oh, no, because it's on ABC. Granted, it's a little bit later. It's at 10 o'clock, so we can get a little bit more risque.
Yeah.
And have maybe a little bit more skin and sexual tension between characters.
Yeah, I love What's It Sky, which See? She's now... She doesn't go
she's
by
Daisy.
Sky. She's Daisy now.
Yeah, she's Daisy now.
She always has been Daisy, but we didn't know.
Yeah.
And for a while. And then she's Quake.
Yeah. I prefer Jenna. Gemma Simmons.
Man. Gemma. Cute. She's really cute.
It's the brain, man. It's the brain.
Yeah.
That's what it is. Yeah, I'm sorry. That sexy.
She is adorable.
That brain's sexy.
She is adorable.
And she's so awkward.
She is. It's wonderful, isn't it?
Yeah, it's great.
It's fantastic.
I love it. And then the actress is just fantastic. I mean,
I have a buddy, and he's like super into May.
Melinda
May?
Like,
yes.
Milan. Into Milan.
And it's funny because like, well,
or
Chun-Li. She's a badass. She's a badass.
You do know she was Chun-Li in the first Street Fighter film, right?
Is she?
The one with Jean-Claude Van Damme and Raul Julia. She was Chun-Li.
Who was Bishop in that? Was that?
Bishop?
Not Bishop.
Bison?
Bison. Who was Bishop? Bison?
Raul Julia.
Huh?
Raul Julia.
I thought it was...
It's Raul Julia.
I thought it was the guy that plays...
Gomez Adams from the Adams Family.
Oh, yeah. Okay,
so,
I was getting
Raul
him...
Julia.
I was getting him confused with the guy that's in Rocky Horror Picture Show. Tim Curry. I don't know why I was getting those two confused.
Well, they would have been close to the same age. I mean,
yeah.
Would have been.
So...
Raul Julia has been dead for many, many years. Probably close to like 20 years.
That's
now.
One of my nicknames, actually.
What, Raw Julia?
Gomez Adams.
Gomez?
Yeah.
You're going to do that for Halloween?
It's the mustache, and it's also because I'm a very passionate.
Debonair.
You know, yeah, with my woman, I'm very...
You're very passionate.
You know, the kissing on the arm, and I'm always, like, massaging her, you know, giving her rubs and stuff.
Yeah. Raw Julia was great, but he'll never hold a handle to John Austin.
Tim Curry? Oh.
John Austin was the Gomez Adams for me. I mean, he was the original one from the Black and White TV show. He was the voice on the animated show. Yeah, that was my Gomez Adams. So, but, yeah, we're going to be expecting some pretty cool stuff to come out on the TV in the near future. And then we got Luke Cage coming up really soon.
Oh, my God, yes! I'm so jacked off about that.
We started watching Daredevil Season 1.
I feel like I should rewatch all the shows.
Daredevil Season 1, Jessica Jones, Daredevil Season 2. And then by that time, poof, we'll have Luke Cage right in our hands. All 13 hours
of it. You're pretty much watching chronologically if you watch like Season 1 of Daredevil.
Season 1 of Jessica Jones.
Season 1 of Jessica Jones and Season 2 of Daredevil.
And then Luke Cage.
And then Luke Cage.
I mean, you could kind of sprinkle in the movies there. Like, in between, like, right before Daredevil Season 1, Avengers happens. Like, within a matter of months.
Uh-huh.
Okay? In between, right before Daredevil Season 2 happens, it's Age of Ultron. And they even mention, like, dropping Sokovia, you know? So, definitely something to check out. Luke Cage, excited about. Especially the new trailer that came out where he's like, this guy punches him in the jaw. And it just breaks his hand. I mean, it's so brutal. It is.
I just love the music, man. I just love the tone, the feel. It feels, looks so different than any of...
It's really gritty, really Harlemly. It takes you to the spot.
For sure, definitely.
As long as they play some Wu-Tang, I'll be fine. Oh, yeah, gotta represent.
Woo. It's gotta be, because it has to be East Coast music. It has to be East Coast.
It's all New York. I mean, yeah. So it would be Biggie. It would be, you know, Wu-Tang. Yeah, it would be, I don't know, maybe Run DMC.
Even though I'm all about the West Coast, because of the show, it has to stay.
Yeah, you have to stay in New York.
Yeah, it has to be. So
I wonder if they're going to do some Jay-Z or some Alicia Keys, you know, Empire State of Mind. You know, it'd be a good hip-hop thing to kind of end the season with. It's just poof, little visual of New York.
I'm really interested to see where he's at mentally starting off.
Yeah, and how, if Danny Rand will show up in the series.
Oh, no doubt. It almost seems like each show exists that way.
Or Jessica will show up.
So...
I mean, she's got to get some rod somehow.
She is always looking for that. Like,
yeah,
in her show, she was...
She is always after some promiscuity.
Yeah. With him, though.
Yeah.
With him.
With him.
It wasn't like any...
She wasn't like a hoe or anything like that.
Yeah, but...
She found somebody that could...
Give it to her the right way. Could take
the damage and deal the damage out is probably the best way of saying it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what else is there? I feel like there's more besides that.
We have movies coming out soon.
Oh.
So we have The Force Awakens. We have the next one.
Rogue One. Star Wars Story. Is that what it is?
That's what it's called. It's an anthology movie, and it takes place right before... Episode 4.
Are they going to continue making movies like that, do you think? Where they're going to make...
They're going to make the anthology movies.
Where it's going to take place in between?
Where it's going to take place outside of the Skywalker lineage. We're not going to be looking at the Skywalker family.
Okay.
That's cool. Episodes 1 through 9, whatever, they're going to deal with Skywalkers. Everything else will deal with Han Solo, this Rogue One team, what's the other one that I've heard about? I've heard about a Obi-Wan Kenobi movie coming out. I mean, that's just really early stuff. Early stuff. Early talks. But we have a Han Solo movie coming out.
Are they legitimately doing a Netflix Star Wars?
No. There's no confirmation.
That's fake, right?
There is no
confirmation.
No, that is totally
I
fake.
I knew that was fake. I was
that
like,
was fake as hell.
I was like, that
it
is
was
not
very
real.
Well done, fake.
Yes.
But it was still fake as hell.
Yeah, I was like, that is not real.
No.
That is not real.
But
I wouldn't be opposed to it.
No, not at all. I
but I definitely, I wouldn't want to see. I mean, Maul would be interesting, but I don't think that's the best luck character you could go with. For me, I've always been about old school, the Old Republic. I want the KOTOR stuff.
I want the
Old
Knights
Republic.
Of the Old Republic.
Yes. That's what I want. Like,
you
want to
see
the
beginnings.
Yes, I want Darth Bane. Like, if I had a choice, I would want to see some Darth Bane.
Yeah, I'll agree with that. I would love seeing some Bane. Especially with his little armor thing.
His armor
was
sick, dude. But I just love Darth Bane just because the way that he just showed a different side of the dark side. More of like...
calculating.
Or not even...
sly.
Not just of the dark side, but of the Force as well, which is... it's not inherently evil.
No, it's not. There's no...
I mean, it can be, but it's not inherently evil.
There's a very gray
unless you
area.
Make it, yeah, unless you make it be. Like, that first book is what really did it for me.
The Path of Destruction.
Especially, like, when he had that, like, rise, and then he had the fall, and then...
he rose again.
Rose again.
And then let off that thought bomb, and I was like, yeah!
And then he took on an apprentice, and then... training the
that
like,
was the world
too. So good, yeah. It's just all of it was just so great.
Yeah, it was a great trilogy of books.
To me, I've always thought of him as he's probably my favorite Sith Lord. He's my favorite Sith Lord. But I would say like legitimately the best Sith Lord, Palpatine. Legitimately. Like, he brought the fall... he's the only one that brought the fall of the Jedi. Like, that whole thing that he orchestrated, like, that whole thing...
well, his master had a lot of stuff to do with
like,
that.
Like, he took... he was so... the patience of him and the planning...
he executed the plan, but Plagueis really set it into motion if you go with the Legends timeline material right now.
Okay.
Canonically, you know, through the current Star Wars canon... there's no telling who...
but I think Plagueis is still... right? Is that who he was?
Yeah.
Is his master?
Yeah.
So, I think Plagueis is still considered his...
he's still canon, but...
his
The actions that he did are no longer canon, so...
oh, okay.
Yeah, that's lame.
Like, from the books?
Yes.
From the book that... okay.
Yeah.
That's fine.
So, I mean, yeah. So, it's hard to tell where that information got started.
I mean, the way that I see it, they're doing... they're going to end up doing the whole Jaina and Jason face off the way I see it.
The whole Rey and Kylo,
that to me that's what it's looking like.
I think there's more.
I don't know if they're
going to
follow it.
Told.
I don't think I don't think that Rey is Han or Leia's daughter. That's not what I mean. I'm just saying that they're taking
elements from
that they're taking
story.
Elements, yes.
Okay.
And like even if you read the comic book series from
Dark Horse?
No, from Marvel, they are taking the best of the movies and expanding upon it.
Oh yeah.
They're going like, oh, that stuff we don't want to talk about.
And then Rebels.
But the good stuff.
Rebels comes out again.
Oh, Rebels
and
is
that,
so
that'll
good.
Come back real soon.
Rebels is so good. Like, it just ended on such a good note that I can't wait to get
so
back to
dark.
It.
So dark. And there's a time skip. There's a time skip between season 2 and season 3.
No way.
I don't know how much of a time skip yet, but there is a time skip.
Well, see, that's the thing is, like, without a master, how do you learn the dark side?
Well, the same for the light.
Well,
he's
holocrons do have information. They do teach. So that is one way. Mm-hmm. Because that is one of the reasons that's holocrons and just like the writings is where Bane got a lot of his knowledge.
All the
it
text.
Wasn't necessarily from masters.
He had a master in combat, but when it comes down to the dark side, he read through the ancient texts.
Yeah. So, but yeah, holocrons is that's, you know. But
yeah, very excited for season 3 of Rebels. We'll get a movie probably sometime this month.
And there's rumors that is possibly like the beginning of the Knights.
Knights of Ren?
Like that he's maybe part of it.
Yeah, never
maybe
know.
He was the first one.
Yeah, never know. We'll
you
find
don't know
out
if he's what's his name?
Snoke?
Snoke, yeah.
Ezra Bridger as Supreme Leader Snoke. Okay. That's strange.
That's
but
a theory I've heard, but I don't believe it.
No, I don't think he's wise enough.
But, well, I mean, he's young.
Still, I don't think he's wise enough.
So.
I don't know. We'll see. We shall see. And then we have Doctor Strange coming out. Was it November? I'm pretty sure it's November. But yeah, they started dropping trailers and stuff. And
I feel like we should have, like, in the day and age, I want to see, like, other stuff. Okay, like, we have great value Superman.
Yeah.
What would be the great value Doctor Strange?
Papa Midnight. John Constantine.
No, I say it would be, like,
Brother Voodoo?
It would be MD. No, what is Dentist? DS? It would be DS Weird. Right?
Dentist Strange.
Yeah, Dentist Weird.
Dentist Weird.
Okay. Yeah.
Not Doctor Strange. Nurse Weird.
DS Weird.
Nurse Weird. Instead of Doctor Strange, Nurse Weird. Nah. The petty dabbler of the dark arts. Is that what it is? The petty dabbler? Not the master.
So you gotta have your great value versions, you know?
Yeah. There's great value Batman.
Who's that?
Moon Knight.
Yeah, I guess.
He's,
I don't know, though. He's so different. I mean, he is, but he isn't, you know?
We'll find out in the next issue, because that was some crazy stuff this week.
Yeah. We'll see if they follow through with that show, too.
Yeah. That'd be a strange Netflix show. Very psychological.
I feel like they would have to be very on its own, though. But they could tie it in if they wanted to into a Defenders. I don't know if they're... Are they going to do, like, a Defenders
It would be a Marvel
sequel,
Knights
or
as opposed to a Defenders.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what you would title it, Marvel Knights. Because that's what it is.
Yeah.
I mean, if you went to the Ultimate Universe and stuff, or any of the Ultimate Comics, Marvel Knights consisted of Doctor Strange, Daredevil, Punisher, Moon Knight, Danny Rand, and what was his name? The other guy that's with Danny Rand.
Shang-Chi?
Yeah, him.
I think.
And Luke Cage. That's kind of who the Marvel Knights were. And you just
Is there going to be any dick jokes with Wong, do you think?
I don't think so.
Is that movie going to be like too classy for that?
I think it's going to be too classy for that.
Okay.
I mean, with an actor like Benedict Cumberbatch.
It's low-hanging fruit, you know.
I mean, I think he's going to make a pass at Rachel McAdams, but, you know, who wouldn't do that?
Yes.
I mean, it's Doctor Strange. He's an arrogant asshole, you know, surgeon, or whatever, and goes from being this arrogant asshole.
Are they going to have the Madonna song in there? Like a surgeon?
Like a surgeon? You mean the Weird Al?
Weird
version?
Al?
That'd be strange. I mean, it'd be really weird if you see a surgery performance scene with that song as the soundtrack.
I would love it.
And then Cumberbatch is dancing to it while performing surgery and singing at the same time. That would be like the best outtake ever.
It would be so.
And it shouldn't
gold.
Be an outtake.
Yeah, it would be gold.
I mean, that would make the movie right there. And then they're starting to promote the Guardians of the Galaxy 2.
Yeah.
And evidently there was a big sizzle reel at one of the Comic-Cons recently, and Vin Diesel did a big old Facebook or post whatnot where he was sitting down with James Gunn. James Gunn, you know, presented him with so much footage, and he immediately went to live afterwards, and you could see him. He was crying. I mean, he was in tears. He was so happy and impressed by what he saw. So, I mean, we got tears from a Groot. Yes, tears from a group.
Nice.
On how awesome Guardians of the Galaxy is going to be. I just can't wait to see what Stallone's going to have in that flick.
He's going to be Nova Corps.
Nova Prime, or is he going to be Nova Corps?
I don't know.
We haven't seen any promotional art with Stallone.
And James Gunn has said he will never put Nova in his movies.
So we'll never get Richard Rider?
So.
That sucks. Because I like Richard Rider.
I don't know.
And besides, Stallone would be a little old for Richard Rider. Don't you think? I mean...
Oh. I don't really know anything about the Nova anything, really, other than the new one.
Speaking of other movies, we were dropped a big bombshell the other day about DC. Ben Affleck posted Deathstroke the Terminator on his whatever page. I think it was like a Tumblr or whatever the hell it was. And then shortly afterwards, we found out that Joe Manganiello is going to play Deathstroke the Terminator. And if you're not familiar with Joe Manganiello, he was in Magic Mike. He was in True Blood as Alcide Hervo. And he was also in the Sam Raimi trilogy of Spider-Man movies as Flash Thompson.
Was he Flash Thompson?
Yes. He was Flash
Thompson. I know he's
Thompson.
That one dude that picked on Peter, but I didn't know that was Flash Thompson.
Yeah, he was Flash Thompson and put his hand through a locker and bit the locker.
You know, I'll be honest, I saw parts of the second movie and wasn't horrible. Like, a lot of people talk trash about those movies.
Oh, you're talking about really no, you're probably talking about the Andrew Garfield ones, right?
No.
Oh, you're talking about okay.
I'm talking about Sam Raimi. A lot of people talk trash about the Sam Raimi Spider-Man, and it was the second one with Doc Ock, and it wasn't bad.
No, it's fantastic. That's a great movie. That's probably the best out of the three.
Yeah.
It even had a superior video game. Pun intended. Superior.
So yeah, it was just great all around. Like, I can't even, like, harsh on the CG stuff even, you know?
It was a great movie at the time. It made lots of money, and it was perfect. But yeah, Joe Manganiello.
I just feel like everybody, when they do movies, they're all trying to channel different things. Like, when they did the Sam Raimi movies, they were trying to channel the Peter Parker from the animated series.
Yeah.
Because when I look at that Peter Parker... And just that Spider-Man in general, that's the feel that I get from, what's his name?
Christopher Daniel Barnes?
No, from the guy that played him.
Tobey Maguire?
Tobey Maguire, yeah. And just like his look and everything else, you know, that's what I get. Whereas this new one, the Andrew Garfield...
Took a lot from, I don't know, I guess it was the I don't know, it's hard to explain, the Ultimate Spider-Man, more or less.
Probably, yeah.
That's where it took more information, more.
But they still went into that college stuff a little. That's what bugged me the most, is that none of it has ever just stayed in high school. But this one is.
Yeah, we have Tom Holland now, and I imagine this is going to be pulling cues from the Ultimate Spider-Man series.
I think actually, it looks like they're going from the Spectacular.
That could work as well, because that was a fantastic
series. It was a fantastic series, and they had somebody that was different. Remember there was the popular girl that used to call him Petey?
That's Liz Allen.
And then, but they still had Gwen and Mary Jane in it as well.
Uh-huh. And then there was one more chick, and yeah, they had Felicia in there as well. I mean, that whole series was Greg Wiseman, and oh man. If you're not familiar with Greg Wiseman's work...
I just love the
Gargoyles.
The theme song.
Check out Gargoyles for Greg Wiseman.
The way that they did the whole goblin stuff was really well done, too.
Oh, yeah. How it was... Everybody thought it was Harry, and he goes away for it, and then it really is Norman, and so forth and so on.
Yeah, that was handled really well.
Yes.
So...
What else? That's kind of all we have at the moment, really. And there's not much else to talk about.
Is there any good games coming out?
Again, Xenoverse.
I don't even follow games that much anymore.
Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 comes out in October.
Okay.
We have a couple of more episodes of the Batman Telltale game coming out soon. We have the final episode of Minecraft Story Mode coming out soon. The Death Star DLC for Star Wars Battlefront comes out later this month. Which I'm so excited about, because it's going to have some awesome space battles.
Sweet.
Awesome space battles.
Good thing I didn't get rid of that game yet.
Yeah, don't. It's awesome.
Except you're probably going to have to buy that, right?
Oh, yeah. It's not free DLC.
Yeah, that's bullshit. I mean, the game was full cost when you got it.
And then
and it
DLC
wasn't a full
was full
game,
cost.
And now you have to pay full price for DLC. That's bullshit.
I don't like that either, but it's a great game, and I play the hell out of it.
So I'm more excited for the VR, actually, mission.
Oh, the VR mission.
Like, that looks sick.
But what about the Arkham VR, man? The Batman VR, have you seen that?
I haven't seen, like, I just saw that teaser, but that's all I've seen.
And then you have Resident Evil 7. That VR looks fantastic.
That looks like I know I can't play it. I know I can't play it. It looks terrifying.
I'd crap my pants.
Yeah.
I'd come out with skid marks every time I put the glasses on.
Yeah, it's too much.
Because, I mean, that looks scary as hell. What else? The Spider-Man game that was renounced, that they're still kind of throwing out alpha footage of. I don't know if anything else is really big that was announced that I'm really interested
They did announce Ultimate Alliance 3.
I heard that, but I didn't confirm that. I had not seen any official information about that whatsoever. They did re-release 1 and 2. And it was a poor re-release of 1 and 2. It's literally the same graphics. And all the DLC for Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2
was
there.
That first game was so amazing. Like, it just had so much
packed in. X-Men Legends 2 was what it was.
X-Men Legends 2 was
that was where
so
that was.
Amazing too.
I still have a PS2 with X-Men Legends 1 and 2. So I can play those whenever I want now.
Nice.
And I've got a multi-adapter too. So
that second one was great because you could be the villains.
Mm-hmm.
With the heroes.
Yes. You can run Magneto and all that stuff. And then under Marvel Ultimate Alliance 2, you can be like the Green Goblin, Penance.
Yeah.
I mean,
Penance was sick,
oh,
dude.
Oh, man.
I loved Penance. He's badass.
Hardcore. The more he got hit, the more damage he dealt out.
It was sick.
But yeah, it was a great game. I didn't want to buy the remaster on PS4 because, well, I mean, I own them on PS3 already.
Yeah,
and they didn't,
I don't like
they didn't really
doing
add
that
anything.
Stuff anyways, either.
I'd rather have local co-op as opposed to anything else. Like, I would totally bring it over here and play it on this TV right in front of me. Yeah, because that's how you do it. You get a game of four people, and it's like, okay, let's walk through this. Let's
right.
Sit down and have some beers and walk through this. Oh, so we have Facebook Live again. Hello, live.
It has been on this whole time. Yeah. I just didn't. It won't let me do it sideways. I don't know why. But
it's just the Facebook Live thing.
Yeah. Okay. It probably will die soon, though.
See, my wife will probably be jealous of this because, well, she's got an iPhone. She's running iOS 10 Golden Master, and her Facebook app doesn't have the live button at all.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it doesn't exist for her.
That sucks.
So.
I just wanted to go into, there's something, so, okay, when this whole thing started, I mean, we didn't start off as a comic book podcast. We started off as a video game podcast back in 2011, actually, yeah, so it was like the summer of 2011. Let's just say May, I don't know. And so it was me, my best buddy. I just moved back from Oklahoma. I actually had the idea of Talk Nerdy to Me for a while, but I didn't have the name, you know, because I had come up with a name. When I was out in Oklahoma, I had a lot of time on my hands, and so I used to play a lot of video games, used to read a lot of comics, and actually I dropped off of comics while I was out there because I had a shitty experience with a comic book owner, like, he used to jip me out of my books and stuff and then lie to me about it. So I just dropped off comics for a while. That and when they killed Nightcrawler off, that pissed me off.
Oh, yeah.
But that was part of the problem, too, is that, like, that book was supposed to be in my box. And he's like, oh, yeah, it's not in there because of blah, 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 blah.
So give me my money.
And it was like, that's not my fault.
Yeah.
You know? Like, but anyways. I know what it was. It was one of those situations where, because I used to go like once a month, and so he's like, oh, well, I'll just grab from this guy's box that gets his once a month, and I'll give it to you, and I'll just replace it or whatever.
And I didn't forget replacing it.
And then he never did replace it, or when I went to go get it, he didn't have a replacement, and so he didn't have it, and he didn't, you know. He could have said that, but instead he'd rather lie. So, anyways, I dropped off comics after that, but so I got really hardcore into gaming and other stuff. I had my own blog, but I was like, man, I need something like a platform and not myself, you know? And so that's why when I came back, you know, I was like, okay, I'm going to do it. I have friends that are nerds and we'll do it together. It'll be a group thing. And that's why I said I partnered up with my best friend. Went to another friend I had known and he had the equipment for it. You know, he had like the soundboard and the mics and stuff. So went with him, you know, and so he was like our producer and stuff. And it was, like I said, it was a video game podcast at first. And we tried to use Gamefly, and I even went to Gamefly, like, not to headquarters or anything, but I emailed them, and I was like, hey, we're doing this podcast, you know, where we review video games, and we're having a little trouble getting brand new games on time. Yeah, to review, and that's what we want to do. We want to review the games of that month. But they would be, we'd have to wait like a week or two before we'd get, because of the availability, would be crap, right?
Yeah.
And so, still one of the problems to this day about that service. Which I can understand how the system is set up.
Supply and demand.
They can't buy too many, because then they'll have too many left over when the popularity goes down, and then they'll be selling them super cheap, and they'll be, it'll be at a loss.
Yeah.
Right? I get it. But at the same time, if you can't give people the games that they want when they come out, what's the point of your service other than to play older games? Well, I could just go to Gamers Anonymous if I want to do that, you know, if I want to buy older games or I want to have or play older games. So anyways, and especially with their return service, it's just like you would buy a game and then you could return it and it's no big, right? So anyways, point is, that didn't pan out, and getting games is expensive.
Yes.
Like, so if you buy the games outright, you know, it's expensive. Even if you split it halfers, you know, we would do that. It's still, you're dropping $30 each, and if there's, you know how they do it, and I hate it that they do it this way, I really wish, and games would kill if they would do, like, if they were dropped throughout the year instead of during just the
holiday seasons.
The holiday seasons, yes, drives me up the wall.
I'm trying to buy Christmas here, and you're putting this game out that I want to spend money on, but I can't because I'm trying to buy Christmas.
Right, so you legitimately have to make the choice, like, be selfish and buy myself a game or get my family gifts or my wife or whoever, right?
Yeah.
So it's a horrible choice that they put us in that predicament, you know? That, or you could be like, hey, Mom, can you buy me this gift and just not get me a gift for Christmas?
Wish list.
You know, and it's like, or you have to wait months until after. But anyways, or whoever, you know how it works.
Yeah.
It's bull. I don't know why they do that. It drives me up the wall.
Well, it could be worse.
Like, I've heard that they do it because Europeans take, like, legitimate long vacations and stuff. But I'm like, then wouldn't they just have the time to play those games?
Later when they're in their
vacation? Like, that's what I do on my vacation. You know, like, when I used to when I was a kid, right? Like, during the summer, I would just play the hell out of games.
Oh, yeah. I go to my local public library, rent a few games here and there. It was cheap, and then I'd return them when I was done. And, yeah, I played some really good games and some really crap games, too.
So, yeah, it's just one of those things where it's like, that, to me, that's, I just proved your little theory wrong, I feel like, you know? Kids are going to play games during the summer, and even then, probably adults as well, you know? So, like some people, they'll call in when brand new game comes out.
Like Fallout 4.
They'll call in for like a week or two.
People call it out for Fallout 4.
That makes sense, because it's a long-ass game, and you need that time to, like, start the game, you know what I mean? So it didn't pan out. And then they had the new 52 starting. So we're like, hey, guess what? That sounds like it's a perfect time for us to get into comics.
Yep.
So we did. And we didn't get into every title. Like, we didn't cover every title. Obviously, ones that we did not care about, we did not get into.
Obviously.
Then there was ones that we didn't imagine would be good, and they were amazing. Like Animal Man. You know, Swamp Thing. Like, those kinds of books ended up being amazing, so you had to get into them. You know, and then it was really hard to find the number ones.
Yep, because they were selling like hotcakes.
Yeah, they were. I wonder if they're worth any money. Because we actually gave Green Lantern... Well, we had a little thing going, actually, we tried to do. I wonder if it would work now. I don't know. But we had like an auction thing type going on where we would have like, hey, remember when comics used to be super cheap? We want to do that for people. So we would do that even with our number one issues, with our new 52 issues. And we're like, hey, we're going to, like, the bid form is going to be like 5 cents.
Oh, wow.
So you would put in bids for it, you know, and then we would have like, we would do like a random selector and whoever, but most of the time nobody would put in. Mm-hmm. And it was weird because when people would put in, they would be like, they would put in like that dude that wanted that. I think he put in like $20 and it's like, we hated that book.
Yeah.
And we're like, we'll gladly send you this book. We hated it, you know?
Yeah.
And then I think someone got the Flash number one, which I'm so regret getting rid of that book because I loved it so much. And just because it was so amazing. That one, yeah, like, was probably only for, like a maybe $1.25, you know?
Nice.
It's, like, didn't even pay for mailing it out or whatever. You know what I mean? Yeah. And then, you know, that was just me. That was me and AJ doing it at first. Then the ambassador came along because we still did video game podcasts, but it was mostly comic book based, you know, and we did other stuff, too. And so then it was the ambassador and it was, and AJ, and then I think then it was me and the ambassador for a long time.
Yeah.
And then
that's when I started listening, is when it was you and the ambassador.
So, and then, yeah. And then it was me and him for a long time. And then he left and I was doing it by myself for a little bit. And then for a little bit on and off. And then you came on. So, and it's been great. It's been great having you on the podcast. It's been wonderful.
Yeah.
It's been a blast.
Glad to be here whenever I can. Yeah.
So.
Life does happen, huh?
Yeah. You know, and that's another thing. I found out that there is other Talk Nerdy to Me podcasts. And I was tempted. I was and am still tempted to reach out to those other podcasts and say, we should just make like a Megatron. We should make like a Talk Nerdy to Me like Megatron and just like form up, you know, or Voltron or whatever, you know what I mean? And just be like a greater, you know.
If it was Transformers, it'd be a combiner.
Yeah, yeah. For sure.
I think
or it'd be like the Dragon Zord goes with the you know.
The Brontosaurus Zord.
Yes, like they just all combine. Yeah. Yeah. So.
Yeah, that'd be an awesome Talk Nerdy to Me network.
Because, or like, if you do written reviews, I would love to have written reviews on our site.
Yeah.
If you do reviews of, like, we don't have enough video game content. I wish I could, wish I could play more video games. But if there's somebody out there that plays video games, especially that's local, you don't have to be local, but anybody that's out there in the Twitterverse, you know, wherever.
Write a review.
By all means, I would love to have your written reviews or your video reviews or anything. I love promoting other people. Like,
yeah.
I feel like one of the things that I am best at, honestly, is promoting, just period. Like, being a promoter.
Your street team, man. Street
and
team.
So, I just hammer it out, like, on Twitter and other stuff. Like, on all the social medias, but mostly Twitter, because that's where it's really at. That's where it's really about. So, yeah, if anybody is interested, by all means, gladly
reach out,
be part of the team. Like, whether it's part of the comic book podcast, whether it's your own thing, if you're local, if you're not local, you know, especially if you're one of the Talk Nerdy to Me's out there.
Yeah.
You know, like, I would love to, like I said, form into a giant.
And I'll form the head.
So, I want to be the, no, crotch. I want to be the crotch potty. You know, from the chest pubes to the ball throw, you know. that's
oh, so man. This is totally unedited, man. I love
hey,
it.
There's no cussing though. No. We're not cussing.
We are definitely not winging it.
So yeah. But you know, I mean, everybody has those. That's a natural thing of life. Like, that's something that weirds me out, is the like, oh, you know, when people talk about like penises or vaginas, it's like, you either have one or the other.
It's kind of human
unless
anatomy.
Unless you're born as a hermaphrodite, then you have
both.
You're lucky.
And then if you have none, I'm sorry for you. Cause
so, but you know what I mean? Like, And then you'll usually end up getting one or the other at some point. I feel like you would if you can afford it. Or I don't know. Is that something that can just be donated?
I don't know.
Like, is that an organ?
Could you take that off a cadaver and you know, Frankenstein it on or off or whatever?
I feel like it would be easier to make a vagine than it to be a penile.
I have no clue of the medical process, nor do I have any interest in learning that information. So,
but anyways, regardless, I like promoting other people. The thing is that I have had a horrible... We, this podcast, this website, all of it, have had horrible experiences with promoting people when they start off, and then when they pick up, they go, peace, we don't need your help anymore, laters. Which is hurtful. Yeah. That's hurtful to me.
It's like, we help you out.
We're we don't even ask anything of them at first, because...
They're so new.
They're so new. Hey, you know, we want to help you out. Like, we are just doing what we... kind of wish somebody would have done for us, you know? And then when we go, hey, would you mind promoting for us? Like, now that we've been doing it for you for like a year or whatever? And they're like, nope, don't need your help. And it's like...
Don't contact us, we'll call you. All right,
okay. So yeah, that's unfortunate, you know? But, you know, there is some people that do pay back the favor and stuff, you know? Like Joel Valley, for example.
Joel
he had me
awesome, man.
On his show, and he's like, hey, why don't you come on the show? You know, why don't you do our last and final comic book review? And that was a blast. And it was a great honor. And he's like, you know, you can talk nerd to me and, you know, and stuff. And so it was great. That was fantastic.
In turn, so let's currently promote Joel and say, check out his movie, A Beautiful Prison.
It's really interesting. It's really cool.
It's great. I could actually sit down and write a review about it.
Zombie movie meets, like...
Mystery.
Like
meets,
a mindscape type thing.
It's
dreamscape.
Trippy.
Yeah, it is trippy and it's really
but
interesting.
It's well done.
It's really good.
Joel, great job.
So,
and
I give total praises to people that are like legitimately do stuff. Like, there's people out there and they're like, yeah, I went to school for this. And it's like, then how about you
do something with it?
Do it, you know? And it's like, you can even invite them out to be like, oh, why don't you go with me to go mingle with
other
like-minded people?
Yeah.
And they're like, nope, no, mm-mm. And it's like, all right, that doesn't...
It's like being
sense.
A musician and not wanting to go meet and...
Other musicians.
Collaborate with other musicians.
How are you going to make your own band? And
well,
like,
on top of that, how are you going to change and evolve with the times? I mean, music is an evolution.
Yeah.
You can't do it all by yourself unless you're like a complete super genius. Mm-hmm. And nobody's Kanye West, of course. Not even Kanye West. I saw a video on his arrogance a couple of days ago, so
I can't
take the joke.
Yeah, it's astounding. It's astounding. So I want to work with more people. I want to promote more people. That's something this is going to be my promo right here, is right now. If you become part of this crew and you're a local, even if you're not a local, I don't know what exactly I could do for you as far as like certain things, but I know if you're a local and you become part of this crew, discounts, whether it be comics, whether it be graphic novels, pretty much anything, you know, whatever, like anything that you can order at like Twin Suns. Discounts. Yep. Okay, right there. Same thing, like comics, Age Comics, comic book discounts. Same thing, Gamers Anonymous, video game discounts. You know? Those are things to look forward to if you're legitimately part of the squad and you produce content and you put in, you know? You put out.
Yeah, you put out.
Yeah. You put in... And you put out,
like the slot machines at the casino.
Yes, exactly.
You got to put in, and then they put out.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Give a little, get a little. Yeah. You know. So yeah, that's it. You know, and hey, if it doesn't, it doesn't. You know, whatever. I'll just I'm great. I mean, I love working with people.
Yeah.
You know,
he's not too bad to work with either.
But I gotta say, most of the time I am a one-man wolf pack, you know?
Yeah.
So,
We need to do some retro gaming soon, man.
I feel like we do.
We need to pull out like an old NES and play like the classic Ninja Turtles games, or remember the old Batman, the first Batman game where you could jump across the walls and stuff?
Yes.
That was so hardcore.
I have it. I have it, actually. Yeah, I haven't messed with my NES because I need to clean it out.
I've got it on my Wii. Everything's like emulated on my Wii.
Nice.
Because I've gotten rid of all my old consoles, with the exception of like my PS2 and newer. So
I want to get a Nintendo 64.
So yeah, look at that! Oh yeah, gun, the gunner. It's the gunner.
That's not why. But yeah. So yeah, future. I'm gonna keep doing my thing. You know, like, I'm going to keep on making the videos. I want to, you know, I now have this great thing going on with Gamers Anonymous. If you've seen the newest Destiny video, you've seen that, you know, sponsored by, and that's something I want people to know, that when I say sponsors or sponsored by, they don't give us money. Oh. Like, we're not getting, I don't get paid for this. Do you get paid for this?
No.
Okay, so good.
My wife pays me no mind. I mean, it's about the only thing I get paid in.
Nice.
It's just a joke. My wife's probably watching this, probably cussing at me now. She pays me mind.
So, but yeah, you know, like, we don't get paid. We haven't got paid ever at any point during this whole time this thing has existed.
This is our opinions and unbiased. I mean, we're not saying, hey, you know, we pay you and you do this opinion. No. This is how we feel.
I mean, we have a PayPal. If you want to give us money, by all means, go ahead. Yeah. I have mentioned in the past, you know, when we reach $10, we're going to donate half to, I'm going to donate half to, like, a charity, you know.
Well, there's a hospital right down the road.
Or a GoFundMe or something. Hospitals.
Dude, you could get, like, the
They're corporate first. Companies. I don't support that.
No, I'm talking about, we can get, like,
They're
the
just money-making. They're just money-making. Like, oh, yeah. My wife works, and I just... so much, and then, you know, the pharma, you know, and all that.
Yeah.
It's just a business. Everything is just capitalist. You know, capitalism has made this country great, but it's also ruining it. So, anyways, that's
a whole different.
That's
not
a
nerdy.
Whole different, yeah.
That's a not nerdy podcaster. You
Talk
know,
political
stream.
To me. I don't know. I don't know. Anyways.
Talk BS to me.
Yeah.
Because that's politics right there. Anyway.
Yeah, essentially.
Back to the nerdy stuff.
But yeah, so, you know, I'm going to keep doing the videos, you know, the Talking Nerdy vlogcasts, continue doing, you know, whatever. If I can work with people, I'll work with people, you know, like, for sure. I can do more stuff. Definitely. And that's to come.
I was considering starting to post the Dragon Ball Super episodes, because I tag you in my post for Dragon Ball Super every Sunday morning whenever I first see the first version of the subtitles.
Yeah.
I was thinking about actually posting that in the community and letting the community see the episodes when we see them.
Sure.
I mean,
if you want, definitely.
I would like to see just some input from people. Hey.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing.
We need voices from out there. You,
yes,
the person,
that's the biggest
the
thing.
The person that's right there, the one I'm pointing at, you need to talk to us so we know what the heck's going on here.
That's what I don't... That's something that I don't get, Senor, is we have people that are the local New Mexicans. They're making their own page. They're making their own pages, their own groups. Why? When there's Talk Nerdy to Me.
Join the club!
Join it. Join the group. Follow
Hold
the
on. We have to do it right. Join me, and together we will rule the galaxy as nerdy people. Right?
Yes.
Okay. That was horrible.
Let nerddom reign.
We have cookies.
So there is legitimately peanut butter cookies back there that we had. There's two more.
Yeah, we went. You want one? I'll go grab it for you.
No,
we'll just eat it right here.
We could. That's what we're gonna do. Eat cookies on the live.
live stream of us eating cookies.
Yeah, it just blows my mind. Why are you going to start your own little thing when there's something that already exists that's exactly like it and it's local?
And we just need contributors.
Here's the other thing, too, is like, yeah, I don't want a lot. I just want like-minded people to just BS and talk nerdy with me. I want to talk nerdy to you. I want you to talk nerdy to me. That's it. Like, it's not anything crazy. It's in the name of it. It's talk nerdy to me.
Yeah.
That's it. That's what I want out of it. I want to talk nerdy to people. I want to talk nerdy to you people out there.
Well, that's the thing. We do talk nerdy to the people. They just don't talk back all the time.
They just don't talk back, yes.
So more feedback, you know, please.
And that's the thing. That's what I'm saying, is that there's somebody out there, there's people out there that will start their own pages, their own groups, their own things. Why can't you just talk to us in ours or start the conversation? Like, that's the thing, is you don't have to be the admin to start your own thread.
No, I haven't seen Attack on Titan season whatever. Tell me about it.
Haven't seen Attack on Titan season whatever, because there is no Attack on Titan season whatever. It doesn't exist. Because it's been years and we're still waiting for a season two.
But I actually haven't even seen season one. I haven't checked out Attack on Titan. That's just sad, because there's a awesome video game, I hear.
Yeah, it looks awesome. Yeah, John Ledoux, fellow nerd out in Florida, he talked nerdy with me.
Oh.
And was about that game. So I want to see. I'm going to keep my eyes out for that piece at Gamers.
Oh, nice.
So to see if it pops up in any form, you know. I don't know. Did it come out for every system?
Supposedly. I mean, the
Vita?
New
did it come out for the Vita? Did it come out for the 3DS?
Gen, I think.
It didn't come out for the 3DS.
Yeah.
I want to get a new 3DS. But anyways.
I just recently picked up a Vita, so I need to start getting some decent games for it.
Yeah.
I mean, I've been a PS Plus network for a couple of years now, and so I've kind of acquired some games.
Nice.
And some of them are pretty good, some of them are just, yeah. That's a good.
So, but yeah, that's it. That's all, you know. And that's another perk that I forgot to mention. Conventions.
Yeah.
We get in as press. And so essentially you're getting in for free and all you have to do is this. You are a guest and I'm going to interview.
Yeah.
Or you take pictures or you...
All the
content.
Camera.
That's... What it comes down to is just more content. Video
yes.
content, audio content, visual content, you know, photography.
Speaking of conventions,
we have a photographer, so we don't really need another photographer. But video is always, but even like audio, like if you just want to go to a panel, boom, just record the audio for the panel, you know, and then maybe ask
do a review,
and then ask some questions. A panel that you would want to go to, no less, and then ask questions. Through talk, say, hey, I am whatever you want your name to be, JD of TNTM the show, or talk nerd to me.
Mr. Kevin Sorbo, do you have any plans to join the cast of Ash vs. the Evil Dead since, you know, Lucy Lawless has done the same? And, you know, normally you kind of show up wherever she does. And I think it would be a nice little thing to just kind of pop into that show and just as a nod to the past that you've shared with this other actress, you know? What are your thoughts on this? Boof! Content!
Is Gabrielle going to show up?
Yeah.
No, I mean, that wouldn't be a question for him. Unless he knows something like that.
I don't know. Yeah, she's a little gingery right there. I remember Gabrielle.
But anyways, that was so great. Wasn't that lovely? Like, that... Like that, I feel like that's how you change the world slowly, is by putting relationships like that into comics, movies, shows, by going
media.
Hey, this is normal. Like having these kinds of relationships with someone, you know, normal.
It's life.
Yeah,
it happens. People are different. They have different ideas and different opinions, and that's what makes us human.
Yeah. by putting it into
just because your
mainstream
and idea is different from my opinion and idea doesn't mean that either of us are wrong. It just means we have a different point of view.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly. So.
But anyway, what else? Speaking of conventions, we need to start talking about the Santa Fe Comic Con coming up. We need to make some plans, something. We got to cover that.
Yeah, let's do it.
We got to cover that.
Let's do it.
Because I'm not sure.
I
got to
hit them up first.
Yeah, I'm not sure about the viewers here.
Santa
yeah,
Fe
you, I'm talking to you. I don't know if what they would like to see or, you know, why not? We got a decent guest list going on there.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing is, talk nerdy to me, is feel free. Like, if you want to throw in something like, ask us any questions, like, or do you want to ask, have us ask questions? Like, let's say you're boycotting it because of the whole fiasco that went down with...
Several months ago, about, what, 8 months ago?
With Jim Burleson and a cosplayer.
Where miscommunication happened as my...
Here's my thing. If we're going as press, we're essentially getting in for free, sort of, but kind of getting paid to attend. You know what I mean?
I'd like to talk to him
like
and get him to clear the air.
That's the way
that's
I see
like
it.
That's what I'd like to do. Because I know what... I saw what was going on. I really didn't take no sides with it, you know, because I see the cosplayer side. I see, you know, his side. I mean... I see where the communication was kind of broke down, whatnot, one way or another, or something was misworded. But I don't know. I'd like to clear the air. I'd like to find out what's really going on here.
Right, and just like that, if we're going, but you're not going, you have questions for him, or you have questions for cosplayers that are there, or you have questions
for
the
artists,
guests, or art. Yeah, anything you would want to see or like us to do. Just mention it.
Yeah.
You know?
It's not going to... Tweet it!
And if it's stupid, we won't do it.
Yeah.
But if it's not, then we will.
What's your boxer size? I still don't care about that.
Yeah.
I don't care about cosplayers' chest size. I don't care. I want to know about cosplayers. How long does it take you to get this project from start to finish done?
I care, but it's not appropriate, so I'm not going to ask. I mean, it's uncouth.
Yeah.
You know, so that's it, you know, like, I'm a man, and so these things pop into my head, but I'm not going to ask them just because I want to know, you know. Really, it really doesn't matter when it comes down to it, because I'm not like... You know, I don't, like, check my wives bra and I go, like, yeah, I'm so glad I know,
yeah,
that, you know, like,
okay.
It really doesn't matter when it dials down to it, but whatever.
And now, welcome to Talk Pervy to Me.
Talk Pervy to Me. Talk Dirty, Talk Pervy, yeah. So, something in our stupid male brains tell us that's something we want to know, but when it really comes down to it, it doesn't
matter.
But,
Oh, yeah, let's... I mean, there's tons. We just want some input from you, the viewer, or you, the listener. I mean, there's tons of content out here. We can make more content. It's just a matter of us finding
the
time.
We could do more stuff. Like, I have tons of comics just piling up.
Yeah, me too.
And
we both got gobs of gaming consoles and games.
If you have an idea... of, like, what to do with those, then I, you know, suggest it. Like I said, go back to the auction thing or, you know, or something like that. Or just, like, a grab bag stack or something like that. Or, like, hey, an arc. Like, I want this arc or something. Mail it out to me and you just donate however much ever it takes to get it shipped out or whatever. Because I don't get paid, because I'm not making money off of this, I'm not going to do that. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to drop $30. Last time I had to do that, I had to drop $30 to mail out comics. I don't even know if it ever got out to the people, because it was in... Gosh, I want to say it was in... I don't even know. I know it was in Asia, I think.
Oh.
So, I don't know if the comics ever got there, even...
Okay.
That was never confirmed by the people that I sent them to, which I would feel horrible if it never got out there, especially if I paid $30 for it to not get there.
Yeah.
You know? So.
Just hope for the best. There you go.
That was a long time ago.
Yeah, you
got
that.
That was a really long time ago. But that's what I'm saying is that, like.
Where's the feedback?
If there's a good system, you know, in place, I'd be willing to get rid of more comics. I don't know about graphic novels, because graphic novels are a different ballgame. Unless they're graphic novels that I don't want anymore.
Yeah.
Like, even that. Like, there's a girl, really hardcore fan of MCR, My Chemical Romance. Well, Gerard Way wrote this, the Umbrella Company, I think, or the Umbrella Core or something. I don't know. Some book like that, right? He wrote it. And I was like, hey, she's really into him. Maybe she would be into this. I even hit her up and was like, do you want this book? I don't want it. Nothing. Got nothing back from her. It's like, it's a free comic.
Book.
It's a free, it was like $15 and you can't even say yes, no.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure I know somebody that would take that if you hadn't got rid of it.
So, as well as there's some other ones too that I've gotten and I'm like, eh, you know, not... Didn't, you know, I could go through them, but anyways. Yeah, and that's another thing is, what? I don't know, just like this. We didn't know, like, we didn't know what to do for this, and here we are.
Yes, yeah, so we were just Nightwinging it. I mean.
Yeah, Nightwinging it.
I'm sticking with it, man.
We've been promoting it for, like, a few episodes.
Yeah.
No one sent in any questions, which is a bummer because people have, in the past 50s, people have sent questions. In fact, I think one time we had so many questions that it leaked in from the into the next podcast.
Oh.
Was it you?
No, it's
me.
It's,
is it you?
No, nobody likes me.
That's what it is,
that's
huh?
What it is.
Is that why
nobody likes JD?
Is that why we've had such a huge drop in our numbers lately?
Yeah, it's now you get to see my ugly mug, so everybody just can go, oh, he's got a better voice.
Yeah, he has the voice. For,
I had the face for radio.
He has a face for radio.
Yeah,
so
that's
what it is.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, so for sure.
Speaking of face radio, it's time for me to get on out of here because I have to work oh dark early in the morning.
You better get to bed.
I literally have like less than 7 hours to sleep.
So. You only need like 4, right?
I can run on 4, but I gotta be talking
you
all day.
You shouldn't be running. You shouldn't be running on 4.
Yeah,
I feel
so,
like.
You know, I'll be drunk.
Even if you're fully hydrated.
Yeah.
I would not suggest.
No, I don't need to be driving on 4 hours of sleep either.
No.
So, definitely don't want to do that.
All right.
And I have to be on the phone all the time and talk to people about their fruit products.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Fruit products.
I see. Like pears and stuff.
It's something like that.
Yeah.
It's an orange company.
Grapes. So...
Lieutenant Dan, he invested me in some of this fruit company.
So,
and now from here on out, we don't have to worry about money ever again.
It's like an online, you're like the Mexican guy that sells fruit, but via the phone, kind of.
No, I support fruit. I support the products put out by the fruit.
Yeah, they support it too.
Yeah, but those are like non-refundable, non-repairable.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Those are perishable.
Right.
These products are more technological.
I don't know. I feel like they're more perishable, too. But,
with a shotgun, yeah.
My wife, she dropped one in the dryer,
oh,
so.
Man.
Didn't even realize it. How do you not realize it for, like, 30 minutes?
I got my phone on me.
So, but anyways, you have to go, senor. And that's it for us. We've been talking plenty enough.
Yeah, we talked
and,
over time.
Hey, and guess what? If we get questions after this, we'll just ask them on the next podcast, not the next 50, but...
Yeah, well, the actual next one.
Yeah, so... And that's the thing. Like, if anybody wants to, for any podcast at any time, want to send in any questions, whether it's about comics, whether it's about my personal life, whether it's about, you know, anything at all. Like, I'm not going to give out my social...
Yeah.
Your
address.
Yeah, or my address.
And definitely not your telephone number, you know.
I don't know, though. Maybe my telephone number.
Yeah, you gotta hook up.
867-5309.
Oh!
That is a legitimate number in our area, actually. 505-867-5309.
And say hi to Jenny for us.
Yeah.
We just totally made an enemy.
For a good time.
We just totally made an enemy.
So.
Anyway, y'all have a good evening, and keep your eyes out for
comics.